couple of other characters as well, and they were going to be sacrificed in a ritual gladiator duel, I guess you can say. But through some keen combat abilities, I guess you can say, and opportunistic attacks, they managed to break out of the arena, kill the main priest, and flee into the desert. When they were fleeing into the desert in game two...
You forgot about the giant scorpion. I mean, come on.
Oh, okay. Well, the giant scorpion, too. Yeah, that was the big thing that they were about to get sacrificed to. So they after they killed that and they fled into the desert, they came across these ancient tombs or ruins and a strange character who was kind of an oriental character who was looking to get someone to enter into the tombs to gather some items that he couldn't get into. So they entered into the tomb. They managed to somehow trigger the booby trap of a steel statue, which seemed to turn into a big beast. They killed that, and they managed to find themselves all the treasures and jewels that they captured from that. They came back out, and then the person that they met, this sage, I guess you could call him, he gave them directions into the local walled city, which was not that far away. And so they went there, and they blew all their money. They spent it, you know, unwisely. Some of the characters are no longer in existence. We don't know what happened to them. They vanished. But all of you five managed to, one night while sitting around the bar, decided to form into a group. And you realize that to get out of the Red Desert, which is where you are, to get to the safety of say, a more northern country, you've heard of a giant jewel that's kept inside the local religious tower that's in the city. Now, these towers are in just about every walled city that's in the Red Desert, and you're usually dedicated to the sun god. But a recent cult called the Cult of Scorpius, has been taken over recently and has been making a major push. And this Tower of the Sun God has now been renamed, and you've heard rumors of how they've scratched out the symbols of the Sun God and they put in the symbols of the Scorpion of Scorpius, and people are starting to go missing and they're not happy with the way this religion has taken root, but it seems to be, you know, taken over quite quickly, and it seems to be very big towards the, or more common towards the richer, more powerful people. So, while sitting in the local tavern and hearing about this massive jewel, you've heard that it's not really all that guarded all that much. The temple itself is very seldom patrolled by guards, and in fact, there's no guards inside the temple at all. Other than trying to find some way to get in through into the garden and in through the temple to get the jewel, it seems like a fairly easy score. And for those who are very familiar with the Beast and Barbarian setting, the jewel, which has now been renamed to the Heart of the Scorpion, is actually a conglomerate of desert tears. And it's supposed to be one massive jewel that contains, quite potentially, a lot of magical powers and potential. So it's something worth getting. So I'm going to start you guys off as sitting in the tavern, and you're trying to get some additional information about your upcoming operation. So, the tavern you're in is the typical fantasy-driven tavern. You know, rough wooden benches and tables and drunkards are laying on the floor, and there's people sleeping on tables, and there's the wenches are going back and forth bringing food, and they're spilling, and there's spilling drinks over people, and just a typical rough housing style of tavern. Music is loud, not very good. Everyone's kind of roughhousing around, but you like it. And yes, the tavern smells like piss. Now, this tavern also has known to hold members of the town guard. It's also known to hold a few of the traders that come to and from the city. So you have the potential of making some information there, or getting some information.
Yeah, I think my god will favor us. Come get those desert tears. Now, is that cult, the Scorpius cult, kind of widespread in the area? Could we find followers or a shrine or something like that?
It's getting more and more widespread. It's still fairly recent, only in the last couple of years. But it seems like the majority of the major cities, if they don't have some large shrine for it, they have at least some small shrine dedicated to it. But this city, the city of Finthaeus, actually has taken the large garden, the temple gardens and the tower itself, and dedicated it to Scorpius. So this is one of the biggest takeovers in the religious sect so far.
Alright. Well, we should probably find out where, besides the temple, where these followers, these cultists and priests hang out, and maybe find out more information. Be a good place to start with someone with streetwise.
That would be, well, I've got it. I don't know if anybody's got it better, but
I don't have it.
Let me see here.
Let me guess, you guys are all good at killing stuff.
I am really good at that.
I'm really good at killing sorcerers.
So I was to claim your first one.
I was so hoping Perry was going to show up tonight. Seeing he plays the thief.
Yep. Is he still in the hospital?
No. Been back for a couple weeks.
There we go. Let me guys see here. Streetwise. You said streetwise, right?
Yep.
Oh, wait. I do not have streetwise. I have stealth, survival, notice, and tracking. I'm the woodsman. Sorry.
You're woodswise.
I'm woodwise. Yes, I am. I've got wood.
We all
I'm just saying. I'm just saying. You know, take it how you will.
I've got an option, though. Let's see. I could summon a Coronian imp to send out as a spy and collect information for us.
There you go.
Sure, what you can, buddy.
What manner of trickery is this?
God, I got it.
Yeah, you guys concentrate on killing your mugs and that kind of shit.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
Yep, bottoms up.
Alright, four summon ally. I go to the shitter to summon it because I need it.
I don't want to know where.
Literally pulled it out of his ass.
Yeah. If I go by the outhouse and all I hear is, keep that fucking thing away from me, buddy.
Chanting too. I mean, I got my reading material.
Mr. Hanky.
He's the one-eyed wonder worm.
I summon him, and I want to send him through the shitter and then through the city because I don't want him to freak everybody out tavern. And get some, find out what he can what he can get on the on that temple and how we can get in safely, and if there are any hidden security measures, traps.
All right.
That kind of thing. Yeah.
All right, so it's going to be a while before he gets back. So, but that sounds pretty cool. All right, what about the rest of you guys?
I'm going to follow and make sure no one, you know, like if anyone comes up to the shitter, I'm going to be like, occupied. And I'll just stand there looking menacing.
All right, so you got Azumut there in the into the room there, and the guard outside. There's people walking by, and just as you hear, you see one of the door open, and you in comes a well-dressed traveling. He's wearing the garb of a well-traveled trader, and a fairly rich trader at that. And he kind of staggers or stumbles on in and walks right up to the bar, and he starts to have a few drinks or order a few, you know, order a few ales. He has a couple of people that come in as well. These individuals who seem to be standing close to him, they all seem to be having red. They all have like red scarves wrapped around their necks and their long flowing robes. Now they're not turbans, but
they're hipsters, right?
They're hipsters, yeah. Desert hipsters.
Kill them.
Desert. Yeah. We just start attacking.
I trust on top. Man bun.
Man bun. Love it. Is this the part where I say I frenzy?
Yes.
Just asking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Flip tables and hurt feelings. Give her. Give her. Yeah. So there's lots of, you know, activity taking place. You know, the music's getting louder. People are probably getting drunker, and the conversations are getting louder as well. So lots of anonymity being given along to everyone inside here right now.
Okay. Well, is anybody taking any particular interest in us?
No, everyone just seems to be minding their own business. Over in the corner of the tavern, you see a table of, and you see three guys sitting down, and they're all wearing like the armor and clothing of a local town guard. They seem to be off shift, I guess, maybe having a few drinks, but they're all kind of ignoring everyone and got their heads down, right?
I go to the bar and I get another beer.
All right. You walk up to the bar, and the bartender kind of look, you know, the barkeep. He's like, "What can I, what can I do for you?"
He's right back. He actually went to the bar.
I did.
Yep. "What can I do for you?"
You just ask you a question.
Yeah. Well, if he doesn't want to order anything,
I'll... Are you just going to stand there looking at me? I got enough admirers as it is.
Not fear.
Very well, then. So he pours up another mug for you.
Okay.
Slides it across the bar.
I take it. I pound it in one go, and I slam my last coin down on the bar, and I belt to the bartender.
Oh, what did you say? What did you do to the bartender?
I belched in his general direction.
Oh, I thought you said you belted. I thought you said you belted the bartender.
That guarantees good service.
I'm like, oh yeah.
Well, I spent my last coin. I don't need any service anymore.
Wow.
He just kind of looks at you and kind of like gives like a hoof and keeps, you know, turns around and goes, you know, serve somebody else, right?
I'll slam my meat paw down on the counter. And when I obviously get his attention, I will ask him for food.
All right. You're looking for some food, are you?
I...
Well, we'll just have to be a few more minutes. We kind of ran out of our evening's supply of lizard steaks.
All right. And I'll... since I've got the loincloth hero kind of thing...
Yep.
I will reach deep into my loincloth... to grab the coin that is still nice, moist, and warm, and slam it on the counter.
Smells like piss.
And just... Well, it's not like I got pockets on this game.
This is the second game now where someone put a coin in their pants. I'm seeing the trend here.
How do you think I make money when we're not adventuring, dude? All I have is a loincloth. There's a pole somewhere in town. I'm going to make money.
Is that loincloth?
Well, they pick up the bartender uses the rag, and he picks up the coin, and he throws it into his purse. And he goes, very well, then just sit back down. We'll have the food out to you shortly.
And I'll growl at him and go waddle over. For my mighty thules, you know, they rustle together. That would be thighs for you layman.
So you guys are just kind of waiting around in the bar and having a few drinks. The food finally gets served. The trader, he leaves the bar. The town guard guys there, they seem to be getting drunker and drunker. And Azumate, you see a kind of a, I guess, a motion to you in your peripheral vision, and you figure from the window, and when you quickly look, you kind of see like the imp in the shadows outside of the tavern. He's kind of waving you to come out so he can talk to you.
Awesome. I like it when imps wave at me.
Not wanting to scare the tavern goers.
Right. So, yeah, I'll excuse myself and walk out. Get in the shadow with my imp.
So,
pimp imp.
The
That's just wrong.
Nice carpet.
Does the carpet match the drapes?
Now I lost my freaking key. I have to reboot, guys, so I'll be right back.
No problem.
My world has gone to hell. But if anyone looks at us stupid, I will punch them in the face.
It's those lizard really, steaks, really I tell you.
I think that the best thing is that horrible computer problems always happen to the network administrators. It's just a fact of life.
It always seems that way, don't it?
Oh yeah, I recognize that map.
Yeah, I know. I didn't realize you're a part of the community. I should have realized it though. Well, the imp, he tells you that in this city, this is the major spot for the cult of Scorpius. He could not find any entrance into the garden other than it's surrounded by a 30-foot high wall that seems to be covered in some form of brambled or ivy or some form of vegetation. He also said that the only other entrance possibly that he can find was a culvert that's on the east side, which allows a stream to flow into the garden into a well that's inside the garden. Outside of the walls, he did notice that there was a patrol of guards that seemed to be walking around the area, but he could see no guards at all on the inside. The only entrance he was able to see to the temple was on the roof of the temple. Perhaps maybe be able to climb to the top maybe and go down into it from there, but he couldn't see anything based on what he saw on ground level.
All right.
And there seems to be lots of vegetation and trees, actually.
So actually that wall could be scalable because of all the vines growing through it, right?
Yep, that's right.
But it's still 30 foot tall, you said?
30 feet tall, yep.
No, that's not that bad. Or that culvert. How wide is it?
The culvert? Well, the stream itself is about 2 to 3. Oh, sorry, 6 to 9 feet wide at its widest point.
No, oh, okay.
But it's not very deep. Well, didn't look very deep.
Well, at least we wouldn't have to squeeze through it, especially with a bunch of fat asses in the group.
Hey.
Hey, not everyone's a sorcerer.
Alright. Well, I guess I don't need the little guy anymore. Can go back to his shitter.
So he crawls his way back into the shitter, gets in and kind of squooches down into the pit, and gurgles and vanishes.
He's perfect. In deep shit now.
Yeah. So I come back in and making sure that nobody else around can hear us. I reveal all that intel. Saying we got two ways in, past the wall. There are a few guards around the perimeter going around. That shouldn't be much of a problem. Ideally, probably not, well, catch them off guard so they don't alarm anybody else. And from then on, we've got a culvert that we can go through or scale the wall, which is about 30 feet high. Couldn't find a door, a gate, or anything, which is odd, but maybe it's concealed through that vine.
I have no problem climbing.
Turok not climb well.
Based on the description that the imp gave you, the ability to climb on this wall looks like it'd be extremely easy. Like
+4 easy, or?
Well, it would be the type that anyone who wasn't skilled in climbing would have no problem, would still roll a d4 without the minus.
Yeah, plus if you look at the climbing skill, you've got some climbing modifiers. If we got some equipment, we do get a +2. Usually scarce or thin handholds are -2, which isn't the case there, so.
Yeah.
Besides, if you were not pressed by time, the worst that can happen probably is just that it takes us a while to go through, but yeah, probably take care of the guards first. Maybe use a disguise or something and just sneak up to them and club them over the head. Make you guys useful for once. That's my take on it. We could get closer to it. Is it nighttime?
It is nighttime. It is late night. so to be able to sneak around should be relatively easy.
Yeah. Tripping over shit should be easy too.
Yeah.
Stumbling in the dark, drunk. Should be fun. Let's do this.
So the question
unless the rest of you have a better plan.
Yeah, I want to climb some shit.
Yeah, let's climb some shit.
Yeah, we can go just Leroy Jenkins on this too.
Leroy Jenkins.
What's the worst that could happen?
Take some higher ground on this.
All right, so you're going to make your way to the temple grounds, are you?
Yeah, right around and kind of stealthy approach, getting a sense of those guards going around, or they're just standing around, or how many there are exactly, and how often they pass by a certain point. I mean, if like for 5 minutes nobody comes around one piece of the wall in a corner, like on that map, maybe maybe like over here or something like that, where okay. it's kind of in the corner, then yep. maybe for a while nobody comes around there. We don't even have to club anybody over the head. We just climb it.
Well, okay. That's easy enough. What do you guys want to do? Is that what you want to all go with? All agree?
Yeah.
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 All right, so you guys, you know, make your way towards the temple grounds. As you're getting closer and you make your way to that one point, just as you're getting in sight through the city and you can see the walls off in the distance, you see the guards kind of walk past that point, and you see a group of four. But they kind of keep on walking. They just pass that area that you're aiming to, so they kind of got to walk across around the whole wall itself before they even get back, if they're walking in one circular pattern. So, you know, you wait for maybe, you know, 10-15 minutes, and finally you see a group of four guards come across the bottom corner, and they make their way up. So it seems to be, you have about 15-20 minutes before someone walks by the area.
I have time to finish my wineskin, too.
Oh, definitely.
All right, I'm going to wait till they round the corner and they're out of sight, and then I'm going to head over to the wall and try to grab something I can climb up.
All right. What about everybody else?
I'm going in the middle.
Okay.
I'm going to go. I'm going to be the second one to climb up. I want to make sure he can get up the wall before I attempt.
Okay. So we got Skullgasher, or Nasher, Turok, Azumut, and I guess Curtis?
Yeah, Curtius will go.
Curtius will go. Okay. He's going right after the Sorcerer. And just waiting for John now to reconnect.
He's trying to fix his toga.
I avert my eyes from anything I may see from looking up.
You see, frog dicks.
That makes sense on a sorcerer.
It's the frog dick buffet.
Got you frog dicks right here, bitches.
It's an old Tricarnian treat.
It's called the fear spell. Fear spell. All right. So you want a climbing check or?
Yep. We'll get everyone to make a climbing check. If you don't have the climbing skill, you'll get D4 plus 2. That's what you're gonna get. Everyone else will get a straight climbing roll. So 5. So everyone has passed so far. Except for Curtius.
Whoa.
Wow.
What just happened?
Wow.
What's the encumbrance?
Well, you threw a -3 in there.
Because?
Yeah, you're probably loaded with shit. You're full of frog yeah. decks, is that it?
Yep. Well, look at everything you got on you. You got a backpack full of crap. And
oh, yeah. Well, I'm tossing that backpack. Fuck that shit. Oh, yeah. I got grappling hook, though.
Yeah, you might need that to get into the temple.
Yeah. So, let me toss some shit.
Like you so got 91 pounds of stuff.
Just make a door.
Why couldn't you just punch a hole through the wall, you stupid?
Maybe I could.
Your face is stupid.
Hey, Dan.
Yeah.
You have 30 pounds of rope total.
Yeah, I'm noticing that.
So I don't know that like we meant to be one.
Well, it's 10 feet of rope, right?
Yep.
And you softly. Probably got, what, D4 strength?
I'm not a sorcerer.
Hey, I got a higher parry than you.
Yeah, you need you, that's from a lifetime of avoiding blows.
Yeah. I'm avoiding you blowing me.
Yeah, let me get rid of that.
Yeah, who needs rope?
Yeah, who needs rope? Who needs any of this shit, really?
Ropes for pussies.
Let me get rid of this backpack.
Yeah, it says I have 16 javelins.
Yeah, ask JC. He didn't need rope. Look what happened to him.
Yeah, exactly. You get attacked by a mountain troll and lose your foot. That's what happens.
How much time has passed since we, since I summoned the imp and we fermented that plan and all that?
I would say close to 30 minutes, at least 30 minutes, maybe an hour now, because by the time you got over there and you waited and watched the guards do a complete circuit, so I would say an hour.
All right, thank you. It's for my power points.
Yeah.
I still don't understand where all my weight's coming from, dude.
Well, look at your weapons too. You got wrong one. Hold on.
Inventory. Yeah, I mean, if you want, JC, you can just disable the encumbrance shit and all that.
Because I'm looking at Decimus here, and he's got barbed spears and javelins and longbows and daggers. And he's got two javelins, one long barbed spear. You gotta go light there, Curtius.
Just curious, guys. I got the furnace running here. Can you guys hear it?
No. Not a thing.
Nah.
Awesome.
But still, that doesn't make sense. Like, it really doesn't. Like, my barbed spear is 5 pounds, right?
Yeah.
Javelin's 5 pounds.
How many javelins?
Well, he's got two there, but he's got one listed for throwing, one for throwing, and one for melee.
Right, it depends on what I do with it, right?
Right, so I'm just checking. I just checked off one, the javelin, because it's still the same thing. It's really one as opposed to two. So you're at 38 now.
Your low limit, that's wrong?
It should be 30. He's strength is 6. So that's 30. Yeah, that's kind of messed up.
Yeah, it's messed up, right? It's not just me. Because my weight made sense when I made the character.
Alright, I'll let you guys figure it out.
Yep.
I'll be back in a minute.
Items. I think I got one thing to check for you.
Alright.
Yeah, I could have gotten messed up when they rolled out 3.2. I had some characters in one of my games that not everything converted.
Yeah, it's got to be the your remainder of your weights and your weapons.
It can't be that, though. So my quiver, the weight of my quiver is 2. My flint and steel is 1. My grappling hook is 2. clothing doesn't count. And my other, why do I get 20? I got two quivers.
Yeah, you got 40 arrows.
You get rid of a quiver. But even then, that's 5 pounds I've got in my inventory.
Yep. And then your weapons.
Weapons. 5, 10, 15, 20, 21 pounds.
Yeah, so something is not...
Yeah.
Well, 21 plus whatever your mundane was.
Right, my mundane only is 21 plus...
5. Should be 27.
5. 27.
It should be well underneath your limit.
Yep.
Oh, and your armor. That's 15 pounds there.
Ah.
Because you got a full set of leather armor, right?
Check. Yes.
That should put you at 42 then.
Yeah, all right.
So you got to drop, what, 12 pounds?
Get rid of your old flint and steel, boy. What are you going to use that?
Yep. Where am I going to use any of this, really? All right.
Well, you could drop 12 pounds if you shit an imp out.
Oh, yeah. All right. Let me roll this again. If you don't mind.
Oh, go ahead.
It's all my wizard killing devices.
So that's a plus 2, so that's a 5.
All right.
So everyone starts climbing up the wall, and you're climbing without any problem. Everything seems to go in pretty good, but as you're climbing, you're starting to, your hands are reaching into the vines and into the vegetation that's on the wall. You're starting to get like a stinging sensation against your eyes. You're feeling like a burniness against your skin. Everyone make a vigor roll, minus 1. And I'll wait for Atsuma to come back.
That was very good.
I think he's summoning another imp.
And he is fine. So Turok and Skullnasher, as you're climbing up, you're starting to get the strange smell and the irritation is coming from the plants. It seems like they have like an irritant. Take 1 fatigue.
I'm sick of climbing this wall.
So you're 1/3 of the way up. Are you guys going to continue climbing?
Hell yeah.
Alright, so everyone make another climbing roll. Plus 2 as usual. So that's a pass. That's a pass. Turok didn't climb all that well that particular time. He's kind of getting tangled up there, and he's getting stuck onto the wall, not working out very well. And the wizard, he's having no problem whatsoever. And Magna seems to be able to get into a groove, and he actually seems to climb quite well. I'm going to get everyone to roll a vigor roll, this time at minus two. So, Turok, you are getting more and more agitated by this, whatever's on your hands and the vines and stuff. So, you're going to take another fatigue damage.
I can't use a Benny on that?
Oh, yeah, you can if you want.
You dropped it in the chat.
Crap. All right. Two levels of fatigue.
All right, so you're taking two fatigue now. Is John back in the chat? John is back.
John's avatar has joined us.
Welcome, John's avatar. But Magna, you've climbed so well. Which is John, actually.
Check out the vigor on that guy.
Yeah, he's pretty good. That's a pretty big vigor there. He manages to scale the wall in one bound, in one leap. So he's actually now on top of the wall without any issues. So you're two-thirds of the way up for everyone else. One more climbing roll. So as you're climbing, you realize that the vegetation is not the same as it was before. It's a different type of plant. The leaves are not as greasy or as miserable as they were before. So it seems like whatever irritant was in the lower levels of the plant, you've now all scaled and you're on top of the wall in this area. Both Skullgasher and Turok, you have that irritant in your eyes and your ears. It's all over your hands. You know, it's like you got your face dipped in some sort of chili powder or some hot sauce. Very irritated. So you're up on the wall, and you're able to see down into the very lush garden. Very extravagant, given the fact that you're in a desert climate. But there's big bushy trees, and there's lots of plants. There's little paths that walk through gardens. There's lots of flowers you can see. In several areas, you can see small campfires, and I'll circle those for you.
Yes. You guys hear me?
Yep, we got you.
Yep.
Finally. Bullshit. Right. Do we need to make a roll or anything?
You need to make one vigor roll. Minus one, two.
Minus two. I don't... On the... Where do I put the minus two at?
Down in the star on the bottom left-hand corner of your screen.
Okay, just then hit minus two. There we go. And make a bigger roll. I'm pretty pimp at the vigor, I might add.
Yeah, I didn't think you would have a problem.
Yeah. I'm good.
I'm also going to get you to make a notice roll now that you're here.
Now you're being mean to me.
No, this is good for you.
Just him or everybody?
No, it's just him. seeing he's the woodsman. But you never really noticed anything.
Trees here.
All right, so on the map, I've circled the three... there's a couple more. Seems to be small campfires. Dimly, small lit, just enough to, you know, give some light in the various portions of the garden. You guys are now up on the wall, and there's a ladder leading down to the opposite side. You also notice at this height that the wall the tower itself is about 40 feet high. This wall is 30 feet high, and there may be the top of the garden, or the top of the tower, is not that far from the top of the temple.
So can we walk on the top of this wall and then get close to the temple and like try to jump over to it?
I don't see why you can't.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Of course, I can't see shit right now, so...
You got herpes.
Herpes of the eyes.
I'm gonna make everyone make a smarts roll.
Punish your enemies! See them driven before you! They hear a lamentation of the women! That is good!
Smarts. You said smarts, right?
Yep, smarts.
That's really not fair. Can I add those together?
Unfortunately, no.
Damn it.
What are we rolling, fellas?
You're making us. Everyone's making the smarts roll.
So you mean everybody but me rolls a d4?
Easy now, easy. All right. So, Courteous and Atsumut, you kind of feel that maybe this irritant could easily be washed off by some water to get rid of it, not knowing how long it could last.
Yeah, can you tell him it's piss instead?
Piss. Somebody piss on my hands. Quickly now.
Magna pulls out his very small penis and starts peeing on his hands.
I pissed straight on Turok's face.
Oh. All right, everyone roll for STDs. Okay.
No need, already got it.
I do have the dead shot edge.
The dead my eye! We are not normal.
All right. So, what's the plan? You're up on the wall?
Magna will mark his territory.
He pees on the wall?
I'll pee on the side of the wall.
So we're up on the wall. We look down and we just see like bushes, shrubbery, some nighttime stuff.
Yep.
Like, is there anything of interest? Like, if we just do like a scan, I mean, I know there's people marching around and guards. And...
Did he say shrubbery?
What do we see?
Well, you see,
I did say shrubbery.
You're looking down and you see like it's a very well laid out garden, and you can see off on the southeastern corner, there seems to be some stone boxes. There's a very elaborate water fountain close to the middle of the temple. You see small... Make a notice roll. I'm going to make a notice roll.
Ah, very good.
-2 because of the darkness, please.
Cool.
Wait a minute now, isn't the moon glistening off my well-oiled muscles? Shouldn't that provide some light?
But a
look, it did, obviously.
But it blinds them, right?
Oh, damn it. Sorry, guys.
So, you see, like, different types of statues and
creatures. Muscles, yeah. I'm...
Yeah. You're too busy staring at the well-oiled barbarian. That's what is going on.
Damn it.
I can't help it. The gods made me this way. If you think I'm sexy, and
well, I think Turok is gonna climb down the ladder and then walk over to the stream and wash himself off.
Those campfires, are those just fires that are burning, or are there people sitting around?
No, they're just fires that are burning. They seem almost like the nighttime lanterns, but they're bonfires, I guess you could say.
But we don't see any guards of any kind?
You don't see any guards at all inside the temple.
Yeah, I'll climb down too.
Yeah, same here.
All right.
I'm going to stay on the wall. Okay. I want to stay all the way around so I can get to, let's see, here.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going to stay on the wall too. Mostly because I don't trust sorcerers.
Yeah, keep an eye on them.
Okay. So we got Skull Gnasher and Magna going down. What about you, Turok?
Yeah, I'm climbing down to go to the stream.
All right, so we got the three fighters going down. The other two are staying on the wall.
You are correct, sir.
Okay. All right. So you guys, the three guys, you climb down the ladder without any problems. The irritant is burning in your eyes. You know that the stream is somewhere just below you there. And I will...
I'm going to try to climb down stealthily, I might add.
Okay, you can make a stealth roll.
Okay. I go down singing, if you think I'm sexy. Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of bronze, not a lot of brains.
No problem. All right, so I'm going to place you three at the bottom of these.
I'm going to whip out my barbed spear when I get down.
All right.
That is the best thing to be whipped out.
And I'm going to put Curtis and Otsu on the wall. So as those guys are climbing down, or the two guys on top, are they, you guys, you want to start walking around? You can move yourself up to your full pace, plus four.
Wow.
Just because you're just kind of walking and you're...
10 hexes total, in other words?
Yeah, 10 squares total. That's for the guys on the wall.
Oh, on the wall. Not us.
Not yet, no.
On the ground. Remember, it's always wise to split the party.
Always.
Thank God we're not playing Call of Cthulhu.
Yeah, I'm lame, so I can't really move that fast.
We know that, but we like you anyway.
I wasn't going to say anything.
Oh, you meant your character's lame. I'm sorry. My bad. That's very
attractive. Yeah, that's because when we were prisoners, he had to cut his nuts off to cast a spell.
Ooh. I got nothing. I got nothing. Neither does he, but, you know, hey.
Took a big dent in that giant scorpion, too.
It's above the dentist. Nice.
All right, so I'm going to use a Benny, and I'm going to make another roll. All right, so everyone going down on the bottom level, I want you all to make a notice roll, please.
Oh, jeez.
Ooh, yeah.
So, Magna...
while he sings.
So, as you guys are climbing down and you get into the garden and, you know, you got the large barbarian just cracking and banging on the ladder going down, a sword striking off the wall, tings and tangs going everywhere. You get down, you don't seem to hear or see anything, but Skullgnasher, your danger sense is kicking in. And just as it kicks in, you guys hear rustling and movement through the bush, and something gets a drop on you, except for Skullgnasher.
Yeah.
And
something dangerous is about to happen.
I grab Skullgnasher and use him as a meat shield. Wait, is that bad?
And it's okay. You can hide behind my barbed spear anytime.
Or in it. Let me sheath this in your stomach.
Out from the bushes, you see three large lions, and these lions are known as shadowed lions because they are very dark in color, and they seem to be able to blend in with the forest, especially at night. They're bigger than a panther or something like that, but they're not as big as actual desert lions or savanna lions, simply because they're more built for stealth. Everyone else I have on hold because they are not going to be able to do anything at the moment. But these lions appear.
I mean, I didn't say I would help anyway if I could.
Yeah. And it just so happens that Skullgnasher is first.
Can you share the tracker? Because I can't see the top two.
Yeah, there you go.
That's what I was looking for. There it is.
All right.
Now we have a ball game.
Game on.
Nuke it from orbit, man.
Can you guys see the top two buttons in the upper right hand corner?
No, yes. They're dark. It's the color in the combat tracker.
No, because it's like they're cut off on my screen. I can't even
full
like
screen. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I have the same thing. I just barely see the bottom edge, and I can't get my cursor over.
Yeah, same thing.
Maybe did you try the right click and minimize again, and then make it big?
Yeah, I tried that. Yeah. Wow.
I'll change the setting now, so you guys can activate it yourself. That may change something.
No, I can't get to the button to activate it.
Oh, you're talking about your screen. I got you.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think I saw this problem last game I played where the buttons on the combat tracker don't show.
But it's not it's not in
like
combat.
The advance and the bell and all that stuff.
How about now?
No, Daniel, they just didn't like you in that group, and that's why they didn't show you those.
They don't like me in any group. I just learned to live with it.
I see mine. So I guess I want to murder a lion.
I need a new coat.
Hey, what are you, a dentist?
Daniel, did you just drink something?
Why is that?
Did you just
drink
something?
Yeah.
So, I have a question.
Okay.
I think I understand this, but if I have the barbed spear says it has reach one, does that mean that I can attack with one square away?
Anything next to you is adjacent, but anything past that is one square. So that line is actually range two from you.
Okay. So I'm going to step here.
Yep.
And I am going to stab garden lion number two with my barbed spear.
Okay.
Uh,
Oh, he aces it. Look
nice.
At that.
Oh. Holy crap.
That's a hit with a raise.
We're having lion tonight.
Meat's back on the menu, boys.
Look at this. Even while his eyes are burning and his tears are pouring down out of his, off his cheeks and his, everything is like blurry, he impales the lion quite handedly.
And field dresses it.
In one blow.
Comes back wearing a lion's belt. So what did you guys do? Magna feels very inferior right now. I am demasculated.
All right, so this lion here is going to pounce at Turok. Oh, by rights is minus. I forgot to say it's minus two for the nighttime conditions, by the way. Not like it mattered for Mr. Nasher there.
So line number two is completely dead.
Line number two is completely impaled.
Eat it when that happens.
So,
but pounce. We could say Nasher finally got some pussy.
So it hit Turok as it pounced on him, taking a clawed swipe at him, and it does. Two wounds against Turok. And you get a free soak right off the bat.
Wow.
I do?
Turok does, yep. So all you gotta do is just make a vigor roll.
Okay.
You just click on soak.
Yeah, but that'll spend the Benny.
Yeah, true. There you go. No wounds.
No wounds.
Wow. Nice.
That's because I pissed on him. That's why. My piss. Sorcerer's piss saved them from wounds.
The next line now.
Antiseptic.
So he jumps up there.
Second only to the unicorn horns.
This other line. He's going to go up and he's going to charge Magna, also pouncing on him.
Bring it.
Ooh, combat tracker disappeared.
Yep, it's back again now. Plus four to hit.
He did that with his mind.
He hits with a raise.
Yeah, pounce is nasty, but that also means their parry is lowered.
Yeah,
so.
Minus the next time around. And he hits for...
Uh-oh.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Ouch.
Down goes the mountain.
Yeah.
Now, you also have loincloth, so you get a free soak as well.
Right.
So just make a vigor roll.
Bigger. Is that one cloth felt? Moving when the lion's done with it.
So you've reduced it to three wounds.
I can Benny that though and reroll. Right?
That's right, yep.
Right, so I'm gonna spend a Benny and reroll my vigor.
Yeah.
Hey, hey, hey. Nice. Suck it, lion. I'm gonna have pussy for lunch. Sorry.
So that's one wound.
One wound. Yeah.
Yeah. And shake it.
Yeah, his loincloth is made out of elephant sack.
Of course. And chicken skin.
It's actually elephant foreskin, but when you rub it, it took
my foreskin loincloth.
Don't be jealous, Eric. Don't be jealous.
All
I'm
right.
Sexy.
So the first line attack, or the first line attacks, and Skull and Lasher just buries his barbed spear into it, and just totally kills it right off the bat. The other two lines attack. Now everyone is aware of what's happening. And it looks like Skull Nasher gets to go again.
Alright, I'm going to whip around and spear Garden Lion number 3.
Alright, so it's minus 2 to hit for the darkness.
Oh.
But you missed anyway.
I missed.
Now you can spend the Benny again if you want.
Hell yeah, I'm going to spend a Benny.
Is there a parry lowered?
Oh, yes. You know, you're right. You're right. That first 4 would have been a hit.
Oh, it would have been?
So I'm going to give you back your Benny.
Thanks.
Here you go. Roll damage.
Nice.
Call me the lion killer.
No shit. Pussy tamer. Siegfried.
And he kills that one.
Wow. I am really feeling inferior right now. I am so large but can do nothing.
This other garden line is now going to take another swipe. Is actually going to try to pin poor Turok to the ground. So it's going to make a straight up fighting roll.
That's not nice.
Wouldn't that be a post strength? Isn't that like a grapple?
Is fighting is straight up fighting roll first, and then after that it's.
He's got to hit you first.
Yeah. A grim recollection upon which I have focused. All right, you have to make your roll. Giving me strength. No, no, it's a miss, right?
Yeah.
Straight up miss. There we go.
I strike the darkness.
Decimus.
All right. Seeing the commotion, I will whip out my longbow. And as the garden lion attacks Turok, he presents himself in a bullseye, most apparent.
All right, so it's minus 2 for the
minus 2
for the darkness. Lighting. Yep. Unless you have low light. Yep. Unless you have low light. Vision.
Okay.
Which you don't, because you're a human.
Yeah, by the way, JC, I found out there is an extension called Global Effect.
Yep.
Extension, where you can set up the
lighting effects.
Yeah, it will affect everybody.
Oh, really?
Oh, very good.
I didn't know that was out there.
At first, years ago, I'd asked Ekal, I wanted him to, you know how you can set lighting in Fantasy Grounds?
Mm-hmm.
And it was set that if I turn it to dark, it would automatically apply the effect on everybody. But we lost that extension.
Oh, it's too bad. That would have been a good one to have, actually.
Yeah.
That's a hit, sir.
Does that is that lion aware of me?
No. Is now.
He is now. But
because I have the assassin edge.
I would say no. It's not focused on you. Probably wasn't even paying attention to you. If it wasn't for the big brute going down the ladder, you wouldn't have had it.
I would add plus 2 to my damage because I'm striking him unaware.
Then add your plus 2, sir.
We are the chosen ones. Very good. I'm also a dead shot, so I'm going to double my total damage when I make a successful shooting attack.
Okay.
All right, you guys are just freaking showing off, all right?
Deadshot, that's not when you get the Joker?
I thought it was.
Oh, maybe, but the card doesn't say that. The card I pulled up, the edge I pulled up from this rule set said, the character doubles his total damage for making a successful shooting or throwing attack this round. Oh, yeah, maybe it is the Joker, but it doesn't, on the description, it doesn't say, you're right. So, all right, I just take regular still, wound, I guess.
Still yep. 14. Well, it's enough to impale the lion without any problem whatsoever.
I was shooting for his brown eye.
Oh.
Well, I was just about to let you describe it, but I'm not going to do it.
Did he mention his arrow was coated in Vaseline?
Was that a ring shot?
Oh. He's here all night. Try the veal.
Wow. You guys quickly dispatch the garden lines.
Magna's just going to go sit in a corner somewhere and sulk. I don't even know why I'm here. They don't need me.
Yeah, go
they just brought me along because I'm pretty.
Go polish that foreskin.
Which go one?
Go collect the frog dish. All right.
Well, I guess we can wait for Olympi there to hobble down the ladder, and we can check stuff out. Is it assumed we're out of combat now?
Yes, you're out of combat now.
Yeah, don't worry, guys. We got the lions.
Yeah. I'm going to go to the fire there and look around.
All right, make a notice roll.
All right. Looking for, like, footprints or anything like that.
And you got no minuses because you're in the light there, no?
Right. That's why I did it. Again with the double threes. Jeez. Oh. Why am I at a minus one? Oh, because I'm wounded.
You're wounded, yeah. Well, how about everybody else?
I keep moving.
Tarak is going to wash off this god-awful herpes.
All right, so you can take all your fatigue modifiers off your character.
Yeah, I'll wash myself in the river, too.
All right. You can move yourself down there if you want.
I'm going to move to that area of the wall.
Okay, I need to make a notice roll. Are you doing anything stealthy, or are you just kind of walking across the top of the wall?
Oh, I am just kind of walking across the top of the wall. I'm trying to put myself in position to cover the people on the ground is what I'm trying to do. So I guess.
All right. I'm going to make you make a notice roll first, minus two.
Oh, very good.
Okay. And
can I Benny that?
Yeah, sure, if you want. What a waste, huh?
Yeah, it was a total waste. I always try to Benny once an hour, though.
Even though it appears that they didn't notice you, and you didn't really notice them until it was too late, but you see a group of city guards walking on the far side of the wall, the south side of the wall, right underneath you. And there's at least six of them. And they're armed with spears and bows.
Sounds like what happened to Dingus.
Yeah, really. But they don't see you.
Oh, very good.
And you see them simply because you got the advantage, but you didn't see him until it was this late.
Jump down and kill them all. I'll be right over here.
I knocked six arrows.
I knocked six arrows. Legolas, my bitch.
Just toss the lions over.
Yeah. Throw the carcasses at them.
Hey, guys, I think your cats are dead.
And they seem not to notice you, Courteous, they came to keep on walking.
I'm going to remain nondescript.
Okay. So, Azumet, what are you doing?
I keep walking.
All right.
On top of the wall toward that spot I told you.
Okay. So, eventually you're going to get there without issue.
Okay. Just let me know when.
Yep, you can put yourself there now. All the people in the garden can put themselves anywhere they want. And Curtius, you can put yourself anywhere on the wall that you want. Okay. So is this everyone happy with their location?
Yes. Yep.
All right, we'll start.
I'm tickled.
You're tickled. All right, we'll start with the two guys near the campfire. As you guys are walking around the garden, the light is shining fairly brightly, and just below you, you can see there's five stone sarcophagi. And very ornate. They're different colors, possibly different types of metals that are made. One is stone, one seems to be like a bronze, maybe gold. It's kind of hard to tell in the light. There's steel. There are different types of materials that are used. Very ornate.
Open them.
You're going to open them?
Don't do it.
Not me. I'm up there. I'm telling them to open them.
Open that down there. I'll be up here.
Where it's safe.
Which one looks like it's the most valuable?
Closest to the pool.
All right. Opening that one.
All right. You'll need to make a strength roll. And you'll need to get... just make a strength roll. I'll let you know if you get it. But you need to get a couple of successes.
Oh. Hernia!
You're struggling with the lid. It doesn't seem like it's really wanting to budge.
Lift with your back, not your legs.
Need a hand?
That's after several minutes of trying.
Yeah, what is the brute edge? What does that do?
It gives you a +1 to your damage.
Okay, because there's loincloth hero and brute is not opening up for me.
Okay, I'll fix that for you real quick.
Yeah, they're grayed out for me too. All of them are. Edges and hindrances.
If you go to...
Your library is not open, that's why.
Oh, go to the books?
Yeah. Yep.
And then... Oh, that's not it.
Go to books and then modules and open the books that are there.
Yeah, I'm just saying... Mine just says there's an unloaded B&B module, but it is open, so...
There might be linked to another module before the official ones were released. That's what happened this week.
So how I fix that is typically I open the modules, or I open the library. Open the library and select all, and then you can go to the edges or hindrances, whatever you need, and drop and drag them onto your character sheet from the module you have open.
Yeah.
Yeah, mine are working now. Are we still free to move about?
Yep, right now. Yep.
Let me show you how to open case.
So, is this going to be a teamwork effort, or?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll help him.
All right, so who wants to be the main guy?
Well, he started it, so.
All right. So, I'll get you two other guys to make strength rolls.
Yeah.
While they're busy setting out a trap, can I sneak into the temple?
They're looking for gold. Okay.
I'm checking each other out.
Look at my biceps. Look how my loincloth bulges as I strain.
Let me get my measuring stick.
You have the millimeter one? This is all you will need.
I have the millimeter hindrance.
I have the millimeter hindrance. Nice.
I'm like a tic tac.
I'm like a stud gnat.
It's the dick envy hindrance.
I have that edge.
Ain't no frog dick.
Frog so. Dick.
That's an edge.
That's an edge. Frog dick is an edge.
You guys are struggling trying to open up the lid.
Really?
Yep, still.
With a 9?
With a 9.
Oh, no. God.
Don't make me fucking use my barbed spear.
I'm going to get you guys... I'm going to make everyone make a notice roll. Okay. And Atsumut, I'm going to let you make a notice roll as well. Decimus, you can make it, but you're minus 2.
Okay, if I notice that, I hope I notice the comedy that's happening down there.
Oh yeah, you see it.
Whoa. Oh! Hey. Son of a...
You fucking noticed it, didn't you?
The comedy is precious.
Epiphany.
He's
looking at my ass, isn't he? He's looking at my ass. I know he is. I feel his beady little eyes. Looking at my glutamus maximus.
And I'm also fingering my arrow.
Oh.
What are you fingering?
My arrow.
You, Curtius, you, as you're standing on the wall, from your location, you see suddenly, it looks to be like a group of guards appear just around the corner of the... Actually, I'm going to clear off all these other little icons for now.
Yes, remove the blood spatters. It saddens me.
You see a group of at least 6 guards start to round the corner up here, and they seem to be walking down towards the sarcophagi.
Is that the red circle?
That's the red circle, yep.
Okay.
Well... if I notice them, I am going to use my skills and why I'm here as an assassin and a marksman, and I'm going to start trying to pick some people off before they come onto the group.
All right. Well, let me just... All right, so it's minus 2 for the darkness, and that's all I'm going to worry about. Everything else will be whatever range it is.
Okay. I'm a trained thrower, so the range really is...
Yeah, not significant.
Not significant.
Show off.
This is where I excel. This is why battle is important. I'll have to remind myself to tell Asshat this.
Octopus on roller skates. Never gonna gain you any respect.
No. Oh, man, I'm going for months now.
Man. Courteous. That's not very courteous.
Fucking got you good, didn't he?
All right. So you see a group of 6 walking. I just got one there on the counter for now, or on the map for now. So you're going to get the... you have to drop on them, obviously.
Ah, very good.
Yep.
So that takes me to plus 2?
Plus 2, yep. I'm going to bring up the combat tracker. Just
thank you.
Yeah, make it a lot easier.
That will be super easy.
So, 0.
Did I get a joker? Oh, no.
No, no. Just ignore that for now.
Okay.
All right. And I will add them to the map.
Ah, very good. Now, my goal here is to, like, stay low on the wall, take any cover I can, and just expose myself enough to get an arrow loose.
Yep, that's no problem.
Yeah, so those of us that are melee fighters call that a coward.
What are you exposing?
Go away, I shall taunt you a second time.
I'm exposing my twigs and berries.
twigs and berries. It appears your berries are shriveled.
So I did gain a hit. Is that correct?
You did, yep.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, four better, right?
Yep.
For ranged combat.
So roll your damage.
And I'm going to add plus two to this because I'm an assassin. I don't think they're aware of me.
No, you got the drop on them too.
Man. And the drop is plus four?
Plus four.
Plus four to hit and plus four damage.
Nice.
So really you scored a raise on them.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So an extra D6.
Extra D6.
Watch him roll a three total.
3 plus 4.
So do I keep the plus 4 modifier or just go ahead and do the damage?
Both.
Keep it both.
Oh,
yeah.
Both. I like that.
And don't forget to add an extra D6. Not that you need it, but yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to apply that.
Message for you, sir.
Oh, Patsy. Jeez. I took down Patsy.
That's just an ink spot left on the. Yeah. I didn't know arrows could make bodies implode.
So each of those icons represent two characters, just to let you know. So I just dragged the other one back on there now.
Sure.
So you've hit him. You completely. You want to describe your first arrow shot?
My first arrow shot, as they approached my party, I noticed a twinkle of firelight in the eye. So I aimed for that twinkle that I saw, on the odd chance that I might hit it. As the arrow sank deep into his skull, his body involuntarily flexed like a shrimp, and his head exploded. How about that?
That sounds good enough. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to make a spirit roll to see how they react, because they would be kind of surprised.
Yeah, one of their guys just head exploded. How the fuck do you think they react? Holy shit! They don't pay me that much.
So, let me see here.
Damn, that's some good rolls. It was a good death. He didn't even know he's fucking dead.
The whole group are absolutely stunned and become momentarily paralyzed. They have no further actions this round and will go directly into the next round.
Oh, very good.
I will allow everyone who can act now to also have the drop again.
Yeah.
So we can move, what, our pace plus four, or
no? Back,
or no,
just your regular pace. That's all. Now, so I'll bring up the combat tracker again for everyone. Share. So
we can basically move ourselves.
Yep. I'm gonna bring everything up now. Make it work so it all works in order. So off hold, off hold, off hold.
Are we? Am I aware that they're even there?
You are now. Yep.
Yeah, because it went something like thwang, thud. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh shit! That's the guards screaming.
Okay, Skull Masher, you get to go first again.
Fuck yeah.
Speedy Gonzalez.
I'm gonna step up here and I'm gonna kill this guy with my spear.
Alright, you get a plus four to hit.
Oh my god. Wow.
That will be a hit with a raise.
Nice.
Do you have, like, the Mighty Dice extension? We are rolling awesome tonight.
It seems that way.
Oh, you used the word seems.
Yeah, we're rolling awesome.
So that is a hit, and that is a kill.
Nice.
All right, Turok, you've moved. Now you get to act or run or whatever you need it to do.
Yeah. I don't see any targets. No, there they are.
Is it throwing your spear?
Yeah, javelin.
Javelin? Okay, you hit with a raise? Actually, no. Yes, you did, yeah, because it's 4 minus 2 for the... No, yeah, minus 2 for darkness. So it's just
a hit.
I
didn't put the minus 2 in.
So just a regular hit.
Alright. We playing Blood and Guts?
No, we're not. Sorry. Magna.
You're removing that setting rule from the rules?
Is this not in this rule? That's not in this set.
It is in this setting.
Is it really? Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. If it is, it's in there. Oh, yeah. My apologies. I'll put that back there.
I can move through my party members, correct? As
yes.
long as I just don't end my turn. So I can go to here.
Yep.
Oh, wait a minute. What is it? And I can go that way, or excuse me. Ooh, super spinny. You spin me right. Come on now. What'd you do to me?
That's those drinks from the bar.
Hey, whatever. Well, I'm facing both of them. With my long sword, I will do a mighty cleave. And is it? It's control and click on the one I want to attack, right?
That's right, yep.
So on the icon or in the combat chart?
On the map, on the icon.
On the map.
Or you can just drop your dice on their tokens on the map or on the combat tracker.
All right, so. Oh, I don't think that worked. Drop the dice on the...
But before you attack, you do that, C and I screwed up the whole rule for the blood and guts. Turok, if you wanted to re-roll that, spend your Benny, go ahead and do it.
His last Benny.
Don't worry, he's got one. He's gonna die.
Yes, Dan.
God damn it.
Okay, back to Magna.
Alright, so which guard is that? Let me see here. Which one is this one? That is guard number 5, one to my right.
Right, yep.
Alright, so guard number 5, looking on the combat tracker here. Guard number 5.
So remember, you're...
I shouldn't be at any minuses, correct?
Now, I'm sorry,
I'm at a minus 1 because I'm wounded.
You're wounded.
So I believe I missed. It's control click, yes, or shift click?
It's just control and click.
All right.
I'll let you roll that again there, no?
So there we go.
Oh, that's nicer.
Yeah, that would think. I think that's a hit, maybe.
Yep, that's a hit.
All right, and now damage.
It's almost as sexy as you are.
I know. It's not easy being me.
You would like to describe its demise?
Well, I will run up to them. I will growl at the one on my left, and then the one on my right, I will actually shove the longsword into his groin, and then just with one arm and a mighty heft, I bring it up and basically slice him upwards in two.
Looks like he attacked himself.
Yeah.
And then, of course, I smile at the guy on my left. You're next. Because I'm
sorry. Fuck yeah! You're a fucking winner.
Well done. Well done. Courteous.
I finally feel useful.
You can imagine him from the top of the wall. Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah. Are you aware of me yet?
I think they kind of forgot about you.
Oh, very good. And I'm going to use my assassin edge.
Go ahead.
Sorcerers. Oh my god. Where do you get this shit? That is awesome.
I'm going to attack with my assassin skill, and I'm going to be using my marksman, and I think that's about it. Oh, I have the... do I still have the drop?
Yes, you do, yep.
Oh, my God.
And because I didn't move, I'm going to use my aim because okay. I'm a marksman.
Yeah. You only have to beat a four, right?
I know. I'm just saying. I just want to make sure you knew what I'm doing.
Because a critical failure always stings worse when you have, like, all these extra bonuses, right?
Way to rub it in there, GM.
That's a hit.
That's not a critical failure.
No, that's a hit for the raise.
As anything but. That is the opposite.
And because I'm assess, I'm adding two to my damage.
Yep.
Wow.
Would you like to explain this one?
I think those rolls explain themselves.
They certainly do. Wow. These guards don't stand a chance when they get spooked.
You want to just give us all the golden treasure now? And we can
I should.
I mean, really, this is just futile for you. I mean, what's the point?
Yeah, this has not been a GM's night for sure.
Yeah, we go up to Veteran and we get the spoils and we get the hot chick with the chainmail bikini and we win.
Atsumut, you're over there by yourself hearing all this commotion taking place.
Yeah, and I've got a temple in the way, so I want to jump on top of it.
Okay, you need to make an agility roll to get to the platform that you'd be on there.
And this is where it all goes to shit. Oh, maybe not. Oh, holy shit. Crap.
You may move yourself to the 30-foot mark of the tower.
Did you cast a spell on yourself?
No. What's the 30-foot mark?
Well, the wall is 30 feet. And the... So the way it is... These here are 30 feet high as well, these sections. Okay. So there's a short 10-foot section right here that needs to be scaled.
Wow.
Because the tower is 40 foot.
Oh, okay. Well, that's kind of where I wanted to land, so just put me where I... Because it's not 3D, obviously, so... Just put my token wherever you think it should be.
Yep, no, I'll put you right there. Okay, Turok. Oh, did everyone get a Benny?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Does it come out and say everyone received a Benny?
Thank you.
Oh, it does. Okay, yep. All right, Turok, you're up next.
Screw that throwing shit.
wild attack. Look at that.
Nice.
You get a hit. Roll your damage. Yes. Okay. Would you like to describe that, sir?
Yeah, with blood and bloodlust in my eyes, I charge up to the guy and stab him in the loins and bring my sword up through his neck.
Gruesome enough.
You mean like herpes in your eyes? My turn again. Alright, so...
Over a period of decades, my sexually transmitted disease eviscerates his body.
I'm gonna need a fucking shower after this.
So what do I see? I see the side of the temple, but is it stained glass windows or it's just still a wall?
No, it's just various designs of walls. Lots of them. Is embossed in a lot of different spots. Plenty of handholds. A normal climbing roll would be fine.
Alright, I'm gonna climb it. I'm going all the way to the top, baby.
Okay, give her.
King of the world.
Yeah.
Not quite. Benny.
No.
Another one.
Okay, that's good.
I rolled pretty good so far, so.
There we go.
Yeah.
You make it to the very top of the temple, and at the top of the temple, right over the, in each corner, you'll see the four statues. Well, behind each of these statues, you see a small opening. Looks like a air column that can allow air and stuff to pass in and out. You can see openings quite easily up there to allow yourself to get in.
Okay, or block them and then send some shit down.
Sure, if you wanted to.
Maybe set some on fire, like plug one, all three of them, and then in one of them you send the smoke down, set them on fire, or whatever.
You are an expert in openings.
Yeah. All right. So, yeah, I just bask in the greatness that is Atsumet, and because I'm on top of the world, and these suckers are just full of blood and urine and herpes. All right.
Oh, sorry.
All right. I want to do a trick.
Okay, go right ahead.
I want to intimidate this guy by basically jumping on top of the guy I just speared and cannibalizing him right in front of his buddy.
Oh, nice.
You know, that's the first time I've ever heard anyone describe that before.
Give him a Benny.
That's
so
a Benny.
I'm going to give you a Benny for that.
That's Benny.
Yeah.
That's badass right there.
So Benny awarded. So intimidation 5. Now that's versus a smarts roll, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Spirit.
Our spirit. Yeah.
Spirits, right? Yeah. He's already messed up as it is.
I have that ghoul blood.
And you can give him bonuses too for particularly gnarly stuff.
Yeah. No. He got it. He got it. No problem.
Blood dripping from my mouth.
So he is intimidated, which means now he is minus...
Is it 2?
Minus 2, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What part of the guy did you... What part of the guy did you eat?
Anyway? Oh, he ripped his pecker off. He ripped his nutsack off, and he's just like...
Fuck yeah, I go for the sack.
My Oscar Mayer wiener has a first name. It's G-U-A-R-D.
Good thing Dragon Spawn's not here. He might be wrong.
That is so wrong.
We're tough as a sack.
Skull Nasher, you get to act next, sir.
Did you skip me?
No, you did your trick.
No, that was Skull. No, that wasn't
Skull. Skull Nasher. Oh, dude,
what's on the go here then? Sorry.
That's okay. While Skull Nasher's eating, I'm gonna grab him by the hips and tell him I'm gonna fuck him. And I'm just gonna muscle him. I'm literally gonna grab him by his hips and start pounding into him.
All right, no problem. Roll
that's
it up.
That's why I'm high up there on the temple.
Is that a strength?
Are you gonna like kind of grapple him type of thing and beat the crap out of him?
I'm already oiled up, so I mean, might as well, you know.
It's a fighting roll, is what it is.
Oh, okay, fighting again?
Yep.
All right, straight fighting, right? Not yep. my
straight
not
fighting.
My swords.
That's right.
Fighting. There we go. All righty. Oh crap! Hold on, I gotta click on him. Sorry. It's this guy right here, right? Yeah, there we go.
And he is shaken right off the get-go.
No, that was me making
oh,
the
yours.
Spirit roll.
Oh, goodness gracious. Yeah. Sorry.
While seeing some guy get his dick ripped off.
Yeah, that's kind of gnarly.
Dry humping and then the other guy. Yeah. I gotta...
You lack discipline.
So that is a miss.
Well, are there any bonuses for him being...
Well, he's minus two as it is.
Oh, okay.
And it wasn't enough. Of course, you can spend the penny to try it again.
You know, I will, because I've got a spare anyway. So I feel that this is this will add intention to the game. Yeah, that's
there we
more
go.
Like it.
And yeah. You shake him.
I am going to skull fuck you.
Oh, my goodness. So he's going to try to recover. He does recover from his shaking.
But he's also grappled now, yes?
Yep. So he's going to use his agility to try to break out of your grasp. So you can choose strength or agility, whatever you want.
Oh, I think my strength is better. Let's see. Agility is a D8 and strength. Oh, they're the same. So I will go with strength.
Okay. He's going to try to wiggle out of it.
All right.
And you keep a hold of it.
You are my puppy now. So I'll hug him, kiss him, and call him my own.
So, Curtius, you get to go next.
Ah, very good. Are they aware of me yet?
Are they aware of me yet? No, not you.
You mean that loud mouth on top of the wall?
He just wants to be noticed. The whole game, he just wanted to be noticed, and everyone's like,
talking shit with that pretty mouth.
No, I'm going to rule that they have no idea that you were there.
Oh, very good.
But you don't have the drop anymore now.
I do not have the drop, but I will take my assassin.
Yep.
And make a roll. Hopefully, I can hit.
Okay, so you rolled a natural one on your shooting dice, which means you hit a innocent bystander.
Aha, you fucker.
Can I spend a penny on
that? It's up to you if you want to spend a penny on it.
Oh yeah, no problem.
If I get my hand up, I'm going to give you your arrow back.
Holy fucked up group, man.
Jesus. Oh my god.
He just won the whole adventure right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why are we even playing, guys? We
yeah, like,
sit back and let him do everything.
Like, guys, can you, Ollie, can you just try to roll less than 20 for once? That's all I'm asking. All right,
someone's
you hit,
compensating.
You hit with a raise.
Oh shit, I didn't even use my marksman. My marksman would give me plus two.
Who cares? Fuck.
Like, so we're not trying to keep one alive to figure out how to get in this place?
It appears not.
No, the arrow is sent.
Actually, that was a subdual arrow. He had wrapped it in scrotum. his own arrows.
I caught my chicken skin arrow.
All right, scrotum, so this poor sap is held in the arms of the big mass of barbarian, and suddenly an arrow comes whizzing through the air over the shoulder of Magnus and piercing the nearly unconscious, crushed to death anyway, guard. And the arrow enters in through just underneath the chin and goes directly through the throat, not even stopping as the arrow passes right through, breaking off the neck bones and the spinal column there, and the muscles, there's not enough strength to hold up the head anymore, and the head just rolls to the left and the body goes limp and the arrow keeps on going through.
Kinda that's like exactly how I was going to describe it.
Exactly.
That was kind of like your ankle, right, Jason?
Very much like it. I have first-hand experience on that.
Oh.
I'm going to call this up to the group, and I'm going to say, hey, guys, do you see anybody else around?
I'm going to flip you off. You killed my toy.
Hey, maybe you like to fuck dead man. I don't know.
Well, I like a little fight.
It's necrophilia.
Hey, remember, love and rape both felt four-letter words that ended E.
Now that I've had my fill, I think I want to go inside the temple.
Yeah. Well, there's nothing out here.
Yeah, I'd like to climb down and join my companions.
No, you don't. We're going to kick your ass when you come down.
The bodies are all there, and they're all been well dismembered. I guess this one's being dry humped over in the side there. I will leave it to. I'll get Eric to go first. What he's going to do?
Yeah, I'm going to walk across over there to the edge, and then kind of oblivious to what happened, I'm just going to look down at them and say, "So." What are you fuckers up to? What are you waiting for?
I'm gonna check the guards' pockets, pouches.
You see a couple of tin pieces, and their armor has been pretty much cut and dismantled and broken up. But they have nothing of note. But they do have weapons. The weapons that they have are. Seeing they didn't have a chance to even draw one. Was a bronze short sword.
Again, useless. I will just shake the body and twist the head and throw it on the floor. I don't need the shiny pieces. They just weigh you down.
I'm going to call out to the guys that they're fucking awesome. You guys did an awesome job.
Good job, team.
When he goes to sleep tonight, I'm shitting in his mouth. And I'm cutting his bowstring.
Oh, boy. Best quote ever. Gotta write that down.
That's the best quote.
I need a new adventure. Oh, that's hilarious.
Don't judge, man. Don't judge.
Jeez, Matt. Two games in a row. Last game was the frog dicks. And now it's you're killing it, man.
I wonder, how do you inspect the frog dick? I'm curious, you know?
Yeah, I asked him.
How does that work?
Very carefully.
Very carefully.
Oh, my God.
You put his ass up to your mouth and suck really hard?
There was like some demon noises and he didn't want to hear them, so he said, I grabbed some frog dicks and I put them in my ear. Where the fuck did you get frog dicks?
I would like to take this moment to apologize to my two Twitch fans.
Wait. You mean your one Twitch fan?
Well,
one is left.
Well, there is two, but one of them's actually playing the game, so it's
It's not me, but, I swear. Well,
Dan has the picture of it, right?
I do.
You still have it?
Yeah.
You've got to share
it in the comment section.
Oh, my God. All right, guys, we're going to get ready to move into the final scene here, but I want to take a quick 5 minutes to get my dog outside. So you guys mind taking a break for a second or two?
Sure. Perfect timing.
All right, I'll be right back.
That was excellent, time
for the
guys.
Frog dick.
Frog dicks. One homo is eating a dick. The other one is skull fucking. I need a new adventuring group. That is awesome. Oh my God. No shit. Tell us.
Take a Vienna sausage.
Hey man, I'm a white male over 50, all right? I'm lucky if I can even find it, much less it works. What is this dead thing between my legs? Just fuck. I'd sling it over my shoulder, but it's only long enough to hit me in the face. It's embarrassing.
Look at it.
Yeah, that is funny. I want to send that picture to my old boss. This is what because there's no comeback to that insult. You're just like, shit, he just called me a frog dick. I got nothing. My life is meaningless.
Alright, I'm putting this in a on a notepad file.
Now Eric's gonna go mute and he'll be in the bathroom for about 5 minutes.
No, I was talking about Matt's quote. Matt's quote.
That was an awesome.
We started this tradition where each session we have to outdo the ridiculousness of the previous session.
That is phenomenal.
Looks like I'm going to have to type it.
Yeah, it's hard to... Eric, have you heard any word on when Fantasy Ground 3 is coming out?
No.
No,
well,
we're on
3 right now. We're 3.2.1.
Right, well, but I thought they were... Because technically it's Fantasy
Ground
2. You mean
Unity?
2.
I think you mean Unity.
No, they called it 2 because... A while back it was version 2, but now it's just Fantasy Grounds.
Right.
We're on 3 right now. The Unity.
What?
It's probably going to be launched through a Kickstarter.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
But those of us that already have a license, we don't have to buy it again, right?
Well, the way they're looking at it is like if you just bought it or something like that, you might not have to pay, but. People that have had a license for a while, they're probably going to have to pay again.
Oh, wow.
They're not sure. Yeah. They're not sure.
Now, are they going to discontinue this version?
Yeah, I don't know.
We don't know? Okay.
That's what we were talking about when you were fucking around with your system. That it'd be cool if...
Yeah, thanks, by the way. Thanks for bringing that nightmare back. Appreciate that.
If the new one come out, maybe it'd be cool if the one we're using now was free for everybody, and then the new one you would have to pay, so at least you could still keep that one.
Right.
I mean, technically you can, because it's all peer-to-peer, right?
Right,
so
yeah.
If you keep it and you don't update it, there's going to be license issues, of course, but...
But if everybody has the basic license, they should still be able to connect.
Yeah,
as long as you don't upgrade. Or that's where you might, as a GM like me, because I have the single license. I don't have the ultimate one.
Right. You'd be able, if everybody had at least that license, you'd be able to connect even if Fantasy Grounds went down tomorrow.
Right, but what I was thinking is what you could do is like download whatever the latest or this current version of the demo, the free version. And just keep that EXE and then put it on Dropbox and send it to your friends so they could, you know what I mean? Because if they try to download the latest version, it might not work.
When it's free, you have to connect to Fantasy Ground server anyway. It works to verify that you're connecting to a guy with the ultimate. That's what I'm
right. Son of a no, it's all right. Well, if we have to pay to upgrade, we pay to upgrade. I just like it better than Roll20. They both have their pros and cons, but...
Is there some kind of a... There probably is, like a... Is there a video that goes over how to like GM Fantasy Grounds?
Oh, yeah, there's tons.
There's shitloads of them. Just go on YouTube.
Yeah. Actually, on SmiteWorks' own website, they've got a couple. If you go into the forums, I think there's a wonderful section for it.
I might be inclined to run something. I knew what the fuck I was doing.
I ran Star Wars, Fantasy Flight Star Wars, and I've ran just a homebrew using the generic engine for just dice rolling a couple of times. And and I ran D&D 5th edition. And it when you're GMing, there's not the biggest, hardest part is the combat tracker to remember to share it out, because I kept forgetting to share it out. So everybody's like, well, what the fuck's going on? But once you remember that part, you know, and you load your maps before your session or whatever, it's really good for session prep.
Yeah, campaign management. I mean, like the thing is, it's easy to be intimidated by all the bells and whistles and all that, but you can just use it as a dice roller and sharing maps. You don't,
and then just throw your images up there. I mean,
you don't really have to use all the fancy stuff. I don't use all the fancy stuff. I don't know anybody who uses everything, so you know, you use what you know how to use, and that's all
you learn more as time goes by as you play with it.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, and I mean, I don't get to play.
Right. So, awesome. Back on track.
Let's do it.
All right. So, Azumath is up on the top of the temple looking down, saying, like, what the hell are you guys doing down there, you idiots?
I'm going to go inside and spear somebody. Slash cannibalize somebody.
There's no door.
Remember, it's rape, pillage, then burn. Okay, guys?
Not beforehand.
I keep getting that screwed up.
Yeah.
It's trial and error.
I'm going to go inside the temple.
Alright.
I'm going to jump down off the wall and join these guys.
No problem.
Alright, very good.
So, the only known entrance right now that anyone's been able to find are the entrances that are on the very top of the temple.
Oh.
Okay, so here's the plan. Curtius is going to throw his grappling hook up there. You guys are going to climb up, and then I'm going to tie the rope to me, and you guys are going to pull me up.
Oh, very good. Good plan.
Cool. All right. So the length of the rope is 10 feet. The top of the tower is 40 feet.
Yeah.
Now I will use my penis.
Okay, 10 feet and 1 inch.
So there are no doors around, right?
Not that you can see, nope.
Well, I'm gonna sneak in through the vents.
All right. So if that's the case, splitting the party up even more.
Well, can we climb up? I mean,
who can? Yeah, if you guys want to do a make it quick, if you just make an agility roll, to
well,
say
I
that
climbing.
No, but just to make the jump from the wall to the tower, then I will say that you all got up to without problem.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can do that.
Damn it, I won't be able to run away with the treasure.
Is that at a minus two?
No, it's all good. Just a straight roll. Just to make it quick.
I think we all made it.
All right, so I'm going to move you
all. Oh, yeah, we did. We're winners.
Move you all up to the top of the tower.
Woohoo!
And there's four entrances, one on each corner, where the right behind each statue. Which one did you want to go into?
I'll take one closest to me.
I'll take the one closest to me.
All right then. Let's see. We
are Legion. In three of them, we burn to death.
Well, it'll go faster for me because I'm covered in, you know, sexy body oil. So
You can fit right in there, no problem.
Somebody pissed all over me, so I'm probably not immediately vulnerable.
Oh, that's gonna smell nasty.
Piss and blood.
All right.
Dick flesh.
Frog dick flesh.
Oh, really? Now I got that image in my head again.
It'll never leave.
I know. Thanks, guys.
Trust me, it scarred me for life, and if I'm scarred for life, I'm going to make sure everyone else is scarred for life, too.
What did I get myself into?
Okay.
Endrance, so scarred for life.
So I am going to. I wish I was able to rotate the maps in Fantasy Grounds. I can't do it. Fantasy Grounds, too bad. But anyway, so everyone's going in, right?
Yes.
All right. So I will move everyone's characters to the spots that they'll be in. We are the fallen
angels. New map. Heaven's skies upon raven's wings.
We are the wolves that prowl the midnight hours. Is this one of Frank's maps? Upon the harmless.
No, you made that one.
I made all the maps so far.
Oh, nice job.
The campaign cartographer, right?
Yep.
We are the chosen ones. I could never figure out how to use that for me.
It's a learning curve to it, but it's getting easier. Size the map. And united, we cannot
be vanquished. Excuse me.
All right, so everyone can see the map? Yes?
I see it.
Mm-hmm.
So you each decide to go down on your own set. You're splitting up the party. You each go down to a separate wing of the tower, and you all seem to be in a fairly small room. Each room holds two sarcophagi, and there is a large brass door in each wall in the center. You can hear some strange Conan-esque barbarian music taking place, slow chanting coming from within the tower itself. Yeah.
That's my theme music.
You know, when they all break into the harem and they're, making the human stew?
Yeah.
With the hands? Well, that's the music that you hear taking place inside.
I'm just in time for lunch. I want to know why Curtius is... Is Curtius and I in the same room?
Yes.
We are.
Nice.
Well done.
All right, well, I guess the first thing we have to do is go check out these sarcophagi.
Gonna try it again, are you?
Oh, of course. Because I'm not smart. I'm good looking.
All right, well, move yourself to a sarcophagi. Before I get you to roll, what's everyone else doing?
Can you do the same thing.
Tarak is going to the brass door.
All right.
Same here.
What about old Skull Nasher down there?
I'll go to the door.
Okay. If you want to try to open the door quietly, it'll be a stealth roll. The door is closed.
Hmm.
I kick the door in. Surprise, motherfucker.
And I will make a notice roll.
Pimp my axe.
Make a what's up roll.
What's up?
You poke your head.
What's up?
What's happening?
The All guard right. looks back at you. Wah!
Just as you start to open the door, and poor old Skull Nasher, his door goes squeak as it opens. I'm gonna have old Magnus down there try to his luck with the sarcophagus.
Strength.
Strength roll, please.
I'm helping.
You're helping. Okay.
Oh.
So I'm gonna get the. Curtius, you roll a strength roll as well.
Yeah. But I totally make it look like I did it.
Okay, so let's see here.
Giant skeletal snake attacks. Curtius.
I snipe it.
Eric, when you're doing combined work, combined lifts, the second lift, the second helping roll adds pluses to the roll, or does it add successes to the roll?
It adds plus one per success or raise up to plus four.
So you get a plus two. Poor old Magnum boy, it must be that little scratch he got on his hand or something. Maybe he's a little bit tender across his palms, but he's you're struggling and you can't seem quite to lift the lid at all. It's on there pretty good.
I can skull fuck a guy to death, but I can't lift the lid off of a sarcophagi. Really?
Apparently not.
I wish I lifted it.
You lack commitment.
You lack commitment. Nice. Da. I shrug it off and go to the brass door.
All right.
Not in it.
Heart's not in it. That's a yeah. Heart of the cards.
Oh, sorry. So as you walk towards the brass door, and as Skullgashers open up the other doors, and everyone else is starting up to open the doors, you hear a muffled scream from inside. Did you guys just want me to open the doors so everyone can see what's going on, or is there anything else you're about to do?
Yeah.
What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah, that's right. That's the statement by which I live my life.
So I'll change that to a zero.
Those giant rats.
I will add... So just to let you know, each icon that you're about to see, except for the leader, represents three individuals, three groups.
Nice. That makes me feel better.
Oh, okay, no, never mind. I got it changed here now. So you're going to see what you see is what you see.
There is, holy shit, 10 groups of frog dicks.
Don't worry, man, I have a spear.
10 groups of frog dicks.
Instead of a sausage,
I signed up for.
Instead of a sausage fest, is a frog dick party.
You said each one of those is three?
No, sorry, That's one of them are singles. As you open it up, you see, in the very center of the map, you see, next to a throne, you see a person in long robes, and they look like they're fashioned as in of a scorpion of some sort. And on the sacrificial table in front of them lays a body of a naked male. And he's just plunged. He just seems to be pulling back a dagger from the person's chest, and everyone seems to be kind of chanting, and they're worshiping or whatever, and the blood you see on each statue to the side of the sarcophagi, there is, you can see like blood in the bowls, and behind each throne on the north and the south, there's two large stone. Statues, and they both look like some sort form of twisted scorpion. You see several of the groups, there seem to be leaning, paying more attention to the door at the north. I'm going to move you guys up there.
So you're saying this is Skull Nasher's crowd?
Pretty much, yeah. Pretty much.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Okay, Curtius, whip out your bow and kill them all.
Ready to go.
All right, so everyone got a joker.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Which is good. Magda, you get to go first, sir.
Holy crap. And these are... Do we know these guys? Because I'm late to the session and I missed some of the backstory. The guys in the red turban, I know I skull-fucked one earlier, but I'm assuming these are all bad guys, or we're not here to, like, break bread and have tea with these guys, correct?
No, you're here to steal their most holy religious relic that they have.
Okay.
And you're sexually attracted to the red turban.
Well, that goes without saying. I mean, I thought everybody knew that. I mean, the fact that you have to reiterate it just shows your lack of commitment to the party. You know, so I'd like to point that out.
I have some lack.
Do we see the I think there's an ointment for that, by the way. All right. So, am I capable of, from where I am right now, because I see I'm at the door,
yep.
Can I charge to the fat guy in the robes? Can I get to him?
You can try. Each the squares are the grids on the map. I
don't see the grid.
It's very fine. It's hard to see it, but...
Zoom in.
If you zoom right in, you'll see the lines. Now, why is that saying 7? Should be 17, probably, is it? I don't know.
Well, yeah, that's right. You can draw a line from... Yep. So I can't get there.
Not well. If
not,
you,
not in one turn.
You can do move your pace. Plus, you can roll your dice to run.
Oh, I could do my pace plus a d6, yep. Right?
But that'd be multiple actions.
That's multiple actions, yeah.
So now, I'd be at a minus two?
A minus two, yeah. Now, Eric, what did you ask?
I said, can we see the heart of the scorpion?
You anywhere? Make a notice roll, plus two.
Ooh. All right, well, can I get to this guy? Oh, you can't ping in Fantasy Grounds.
Just draw an arrow.
Oh, okay. Let me move that.
Or you just can just click on them too.
You see, Eric.
Yep.
At the bottom of the sarcophagi, or of the sacrificial table, underneath it, the blood seems to be flowing down through channels and is dripping over this huge stone that's underneath the table, as if it's basking. Or they're bathing the blood, the stone in the blood, and what you see is what you think is the diamond, right?
Okay, dibs.
Dibs. He says. He got it. It's his.
Well, never mind. I'm leaving. All right. So that says, is that seven?
That's seven. Yep.
So I can't get there, can I?
Not without running. Nope.
Well, I can't get there and make an attack. I guess.
Oh, you can get adjacent to it.
Oh, that's right. All right. So to confirm, well, are you confirming the movement or do I just move?
Just let me do it for you there.
Yeah, that's fine. And then I shall attack said fuckstick.
Quoth the barbarian.
Eloquently, I mean. Or I will Benny that. Fuck that. That sucketh.
No, you can move up there with your regular pace.
Oh, okay.
To put you right there.
Yes, and I will stab him in the back, since it appears, I'm assuming he doesn't see me.
Oh no, their awareness was up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So is my scrotum. And I will attack vehemently.
Yep.
With a five and a what is that? Five and a two. So, I'm not sure if that catches his parry or not.
His parry is. It's a hit.
It's a hit?
Yep.
Then I will roll damage.
I've never played
And I will make him go splat.
That has used scrotum more often.
Yes.
Well, yeah. So I'm going to apply that.
Is he dead?
And you kill him.
Yes.
You got a chicken skin bonus.
Now, the cult master. He sees what's happening. And with the blood still dripping off the blade, I'll see what he's gonna do.
Shit his pants because he just saw my magnificence and the gleaming muscles in the firelight.
You need a longer loincloth.
No, it must be small and bikini-like.
Well, just show wait off my
buttocks.
Just wait till Skull Nasher starts eating people.
Hey man, we are the dynamic duo. I skull fuck, he penis eats. I mean, don't ruin a proven method.
That's all you need. Saying.
That's right. That's a proven method.
The it cult, works. The apparent cult master, he walks down amongst the his servants, and he starts to chant, and he starts to yell and scream, and he seems to be putting everybody into a frenzy. He is
Kali.
He gets a raise
Kali
too,
Ma.
So it's a large.
Alright, Curtius, start pincushion people.
Oh, I'm ready.
Oh, shoot. Shoot. Everything just collapsed. Where did my map go?
Did we crash your computer?
So, effects in his fervor, in his desire to get his followers to attack. He sends the six that are in the circle with him into a frenzy, and they all become berserk. So I have to mark them down as berserk. So this cult member, he is going to move his pace. 5, 6. Where are you getting that from?
YouTube.
That's really cool. So those cult members move up towards Turok. And Turok, you get to go next.
Dude, I don't have to run as far.
Positive thinking.
So Turok is going to charge over here and punch cult member one while slashing at cult member two with his broadsword.
All right, so which one's he attacking? Cult.
Cult member is going to be a just a straight up punch, and then cult member two is going to be a bastard sword.
All right, so you're making two attacks, right? I gotta look at your character sheet now. See if make sure. So that is, are you ambidextrous? No.
No.
So it's going to be a minus two for your first attack and minus four for your second.
I would think it would be the other way around.
I have to find out. I can't remember offhand.
Because using the weapon would be his primary hand, right? Yep.
Yeah, so you minus two for your first attack, which is your main attack. So your primary attack.
It's just that he wants to punch first.
Yeah, that's fine. Just minus four on your punch, that's all.
Okay.
And be minus two on the other one.
Ooh, minus 24.
Minus two. Ouch.
It's like Gary in the game we played with John Goff, and he had a minus 16, and he spent like four bennies trying to get it.
So that's a hit. So roll your punching damage, which is straight up strength.
Strength, yeah.
Nice.
So, where is that one? So, your punch didn't do anything. But your bastard sword...
Oh, it was just a distraction.
Did. Well done, Turok. Cult member number four. One, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Bring it.
So he is berserk. Now I gotta find the rules for berserk. Where are they?
Under the hindrance, berserk.
That's what I thought it was. I was just looking at it.
Oh no, that's bloodthirsty.
I thought it was an edge, but
yeah, it is an edge. Berserk.
It's not under combat. Goes.
Parry reduced by 2, plus 2 to all fighting strength, melee damage rolls, and toughness.
Alright.
The warrior ignores all wound modifiers while berserk, but cannot use any skills, edge, or maneuvers that require concentration.
Alright, so he hauls out a short sword. And he attacks Magnus.
But yes. You know what? All you had to do was apply the berserker effect on them and you wouldn't have had to compile anything.
Yeah, but I didn't see that up in the list though. Oh, now I see it. Of course I do.
Well, that's how it works.
Yeah. So that's a big miss.
Whoosh.
Second one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And he gets a plus 1 because he's ganged up.
Gangbang, what?
You're about to get it. Yep. You're going to get it now.
I'm more than enough man for them.
And that's a hit. Roll for damage. You are shaken.
All right. I can... Don't I get a vigor roll?
You get a free vigor roll.
Ha-ha!
Look at the vigor on that guy.
Yes, he's got some big vigor.
That's what she said.
So, you ignore that.
That's right.
And the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You are in range. Oh no, you're not. Alright, so that's fine.
See, unless he has a spear.
Cult number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's two people adjacent, so he gets a plus 2 to his attack.
Yes.
And he will...
It's a hit.
That's a hit with a raise. And... damage.
Karima.
I hear it.
Oh, you were very lucky.
Yeah, that's another type of setting I considered running. The kind of Indiana Jones type of game.
Yep.
And I can vigor this one too.
You can vigor that one as well, yep. And you ignore that one.
Check the vigor out on that guy.
So number 6, he moves over. He gets a plus 3. He swings his bronze short sword.
Bounces off my chest.
And he misses.
Bronze short sword is a euphemism.
I'm just going to let Skull Crusher know that there's plenty of skull fucking over here.
Join all me, right. Brother.
Yes.
Scorching wind on these fuckers.
Oh, okay. Give her.
Super powered too.
Okay.
So that's gonna be 4 power points.
Is that like a flatulence thing?
Yeah.
Light a match. Light a match.
All right. Nice score. Yeah. Score a raise.
Score a raise.
Oh my gosh.
Kill.
All right. We'll start with the cult master.
Okay.
Nice. That's a lot of dice.
Well, first of all, I'm going to choose to Benny that. Cult master here. And he is going to make a vigor roll.
Everybody hates on the sorcerer. That's all.
Yeah, here he goes. He does it again. I'm going to Benny that one more time. Oh, how come?
When the GM has to cheat, that's all I'm saying.
Are you happy with that?
There we go.
Yeah, keep rolling until you get the number you want. That's what I say.
Still has one wound. That's all good.
And he's shaking, right?
Yep.
That means no spells next turn.
All right, now I'm going to keep rolling on the other ones.
Okay. So I'm going to give this guy a wound.
Oh.
Holy smokes, man. Yep.
Oh. Yeah.
All right, what's that about sorcerers again?
Man.
Right. Frog dicks.
I can either spend my bennies on trying to save everyone.
They're mooks. Don't save them.
Don't do it.
Don't do it. No, I'm not going to. Apply.
Yeah, but you did it while hiding in another room.
Hey, nobody has problem with Curtis over there shooting from 20 feet.
Oh, yeah, we did. I told you I was going to shit in his mouth when he goes to sleep.
All right, so...
Me and Skullcrusher are in the room handling business.
Yeah.
What are you guys doing?
That kind of heat that you can see coming out of the pavement, the rocks, and it's concentrating and it's picking up some dust, and like a flash, it just goes to them and pretty much turns them to cinder, and the other guy is badly burnt too. Looks like he spent too much time at in the tanning booth. And that's it for me. I stay right there.
All right. Simply because you wiped out like 3, possibly could have easily ended the game. I'm gonna give you a extra Benny for that.
Right.
Skull Nasher.
All right.
Yeah. Get him.
It's time to fucking end this shit.
Yeah.
He's like way the fuck down there.
Yeah.
Just
run right up to him. Take a swipe anyway.
Bet you wish you knew a sorcerer to teleport your ass right now. Huh?
I want to fuck. I don't know. I have 5 bennies. I want to do something ridiculous with like multiple actions.
Yeah, do it. Give it. Whatever you got.
Yeah, I want to. I want to throw a spear. And.
What about wild attack?
Dude, arc it over the statues right into the cult.
Yeah, I want to lob a spear attack over the thing.
In direct
and then,
fire.
Like, run around and stab him with my barb spear. Possibility.
Alright, so you're going to... I'm just trying to remember the rules. If you attack, you have to do all your attacks? Or can you...
No, you don't.
You can just break it up, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yep.
I just had to declare it all up front, I think.
You gotta declare it all up front, yeah. So, so
that's
you're
3 actions.
Yeah, so you're gonna be a minus 6.
Alright.
No, minus 4, sorry.
Yeah, minus 4. So I need a throwing roll and a fighting roll. Both at minus 4.
Well, you're gonna make your throwing roll first, then you have to make a running roll. See if you can get to.
Okay.
You got this, man.
There's nothing about a retreat.
Benny that shit.
Oh, you don't have the auto range turned on, JC?
No, I don't. Does it actually? I haven't even figured out how that works yet.
If there's a grid, it will automatically know the ranges.
Ha!
All right, that's it. Roll damage.
Roll damage on that.
Ooh, nice.
Mm. Son of a bitch.
Spin those bennies, JC. Spin them.
How many bennies you got left, pal?
He's probably got five at least.
I'm running. I'm getting through them here.
Three plus one for each player, right? On average.
It's two for the main.
Or two for the main wild card, yeah. And then one per player.
Yeah. Okay, so vigor.
I told you, JC, just give us the women and the treasure and call it a night. But no, you want to prolong this agony, it's okay.
All right, so make your running roll.
You're the god that demands bloodshed.
That's a
D6. It's a D6, yeah.
Unless you're fleet-footed, then it's D10.
Oh. So Benny that shit.
Get there.
Yeah,
you can't Benny that.
You can't Benny a run?
It's not an attribute.
It's not an attribute or a trait roll.
Oh, so I need to Benny back, I guess.
Yeah, I'll get that back. Yeah.
That's why I like playing with Eric. He knows the loopholes.
I'm the lawyer.
All right, so you can move your pace plus one, but you're out of range for any attack.
So, all right. That's all
I got
have.
Your back. Got your back, man.
All right.
Courteous.
Holy shit, I got a turn.
Well, you killed everything last round, so give everyone else a chance first.
Courteous, if you kill all my guys, I swear to God, I'm going to wrap that bow around your neck.
First, I have to ask, are they aware of me behind this door?
Yes,
they are aware of you.
Oh, okay. Shit.
You fucker.
Very well, then.
We only rolled it.
Give that man a Benny.
The second thing I have to ask, I'm not moving this round. Does my marksman edge count, or does it wait until the next round? The way it reads,
marksman, it's right away.
Yeah,
it's right away. Okay.
If you don't move, he just acts like it's aiming.
All right, very good.
Sorry, guys, I only rolled a 27.
Yeah.
Look, Eric's a rule lawyer enough for all of us, I think. All right.
All right, I'm only making this shot with a plus +8. I hope I hit.
Sorry, guys.
Hey, guys, I just had plus +12, but I forgot to add my other plus +1.
Ooh. Benny that shit.
I am.
Yeah. Who are you kidding?
Of course I am.
Well, adjacent, that'd be you hit another guy.
Yep.
Which I should. Due to lack of respect. All right.
Well, you're no sorcerer, so I mean.
Of course I'm no sorcerer. It's the worst possible thing ever.
You can only kill one at a time, and like me.
All right. I am going to all my damage, I guess.
Yeah, but if your spell backfires, then you kill your own party.
Yeah,
backfire and spells are bad.
Ah, fuck. Only shaken.
When an arrow backfires, it can hit your friend too.
Well, that's a way to go there, Courteous.
I'm shamed.
Shame.
Shame. Where's the bell? Shame.
Ooh, and the cult master gets to go first. Now,
dice shaming.
He was shaken, so he needs to roll a vigor roll. Spirit. Or spirit rolls, right? Yeah.
Oh, wait. Junkers were dealt last round, correct?
Yep.
Plus two to everything.
So, that's my dead shot.
Was that you that had the Joker?
No, Magnus had the Joker.
Yeah.
Yeah, then it doesn't apply. It's only when you are dealt the Joker.
Good try there, Curtius. Good try.
Damn barrister.
Do the spirit... do the wounds account for your modifier for rolling for,
Yep.
It does, don't it? Cult Master is shaken.
Oh,
so no he...
spells.
Two, three, four, five, six. He's right. Gonna move up there.
Yeah. Hide behind your lackeys, coward.
He's getting away from the sorcerer.
Yeah, I don't blame him. So I'm not sure moving closer to me was a smart idea, but...
Next time Magna's getting it, too, he'll be in the circle.
I can take the heat, baby. My elephant scrotum will protect me.
All right. All right, you clowns. Turok is going to pay...
Sorry, Jason.
He's going to take the wrath of the GM here right now.
That's another good quote.
And the cult member rolls and gets a one. Great. There must be an extension on that stops the GM from rolling high.
We weren't going to tell you about that.
He's going to
move
Ben.
He's Ben.
Plus one. And he gets the gang up bonus.
I'm still pondering about the relationship between the elephant penis and the loincloth and why it's a perfect waist size.
I'll show you later when we're alone.
You don't need to trim it, you know? It's just like a slip-on.
It's ribbed for my pleasure.
Yeah, you got two... You cut two holes in there and you just slip it
off. You're
all
set.
Alright, so here we go. Fighting.
I feel dirty.
And it's another big miss.
Who are you attacking?
Turok.
Oh.
They're just like going... They're just missing. I'm just rolling horribly. Alright, Magnus. Tear some new ones.
Actually, I'd like to talk about our feelings. You know, if you guys, you know, have you heard of Jehovah? I mean, no? All right, so starting...
It's a kid.
Starting clockwise.
Please tell me you have sweep.
I don't believe I do. It would be under my advantage. I didn't build this character. I have woodsman, loincloth, hero, brute, and brawny. So none of that will help me.
And rock, paper, scissors.
And rock, paper, scissors. And a partridge. And a... Oh, wait. All right. I'm going to say I hit.
Yeah, you hit.
Now, does it automatically calculate my raise?
It does, yep.
Okay, so I can just do that. And look at that.
Oh.
Smooshed.
Only one?
Yeah, but it's quality, baby. Quality over quantity, all right?
You got him. Way to go, Magnus.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Skull Nasher. Right.
I want to avenge my failure to do a ridiculous thing last round. I want to run up to this cult leader, cult master, and spear him with my trusty barbed spear that hasn't failed me yet.
All right, so roll a... so you can get up there with a one, no problem. Because that's 6 plus 1, yeah. So that's no problem. So it's going to be a minus 2 to your attack roll. All
right.
Wild
you
attack. Wild attack.
Got this, brother. Well, got this.
Hey, don't you
have...
Yeah,
wild attack.
Don't you have reach with that thing?
He does.
Yeah. I do. Yeah.
So you don't even need to run.
Yeah, you can move you back to there.
Okay. So if I go there and wild attack, plus 2?
Yep.
Now your parry goes down by 2, though.
Oh, I don't care about that.
Okay, yeah, no, take it, man. Do it. You got this. There are dicks to be eaten.
Is why? Why my attack?
Not just the frog ones either.
Not just the frog ones.
My attack is plus 2 to my attack.
Plus 2.
Or you can just apply the effect if you go under effect.
Yeah, I'm doing the form there right now. So we're.
You can take their dicks, but you'll never take their dignity.
Watch me.
Just do a straight up attack on him. Then.
Okay, roll it.
Okay. So the effect is applied to me.
Yep.
Just roll it.
Yep.
Yeah, just roll your. Benny that shit. Benny, yeah.
Yeah, you've got plenty of bennies. Spend one, try to get a raise on that bastard.
Because you might kill him with one hit. There you go.
That's not even a raise. Jeez.
Can you spend multiple bennies on a single attack?
Oh, yeah.
Attack?
You can spend as many as you want in the row, yeah.
Burn it, brother. Burn it. Oh, look at him. Like a trooper.
Die. He will die.
There it is.
Oh, there you go. Go.
There's the raise.
Yeah. Kill him, motherfucker.
Are you
take
going to Benny
moves,
that?
Motherfucker.
No, you. Yeah, you're going to Benny that, or are you going to take one of these?
I'll take that fighting roll.
Okay.
I don't think I can Benny it anymore.
Yeah, you can. It's blood and guts.
Blood and guts. Yeah,
barbarians. You can Benny damage.
Can you also spend a Benny to add an extra 1d6? Not to damage, though.
No,
right?
No, not in this setting. No.
There's no extra. Effort.
If you're playing Rifts now, Savage Rifts, you could.
Yeah.
Well, he's already at minus two, right?
Yep.
So two wounds. I mean.
Yeah, unless he soaks them.
So, oh, I see. Let me Benny and see if I can.
Do it.
Completely annihilate him.
Now you have, before you roll damage, you have to click on that little icon that says plus d6 damage
yep.
at the bottom.
Okay.
Right next to the star. There you go. Oh.
There you go, four wounds.
There we go. Final answer, four wounds.
Suddenly, Skullnasher feels very weak and he turns into a giant frog penis. All right, I will try and soak this shit. What a load of crap this
JC,
is.
JC, may I say frog penis to you?
Here we go.
He just needs to rub his frog dick and he'll be all right. It's like Lucky Charm.
So I'm going to try it one more time.
If he dies, I'm totally cannibalizing him in front of his fucking minions.
That's
oh, yeah,
one.
Don't. Without a doubt.
That's one there. I'm going to take that one. Oh, so, yeah, it was four wounds, right?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah, I got no choice.
You gotta soak at least two.
Yeah. Oh, boy. I got to soak at least three.
Three. Yeah.
Oh!
And he goes down.
Yeah. Ah. Skull fuck him.
Eat his asshole.
Okay. Have donuts.
Tastes like shitlins.
Well, as Skull, first of all, you get the honor of describing this this action.
Murder.
Right. I guess I don't run. I do like some sort of like gymnastics cartwheel flip move, and then I come down overhand with my spear with both hands and I drive it through his chest, and then I rip out his still beating heart and I put it in my teeth and I fucking take a huge bite out of it.
Easy now.
Wow. I like Skullnasher. He's cool.
What happens when you don't get laid in a week?
Well, pent up aggression.
That's it.
With,
he knows how to party.
With the unexpected and quick dispatching of the cult master, the rest of the members seem to become very agitated.
On berserk.
But they decide to run away. They seem like they've lost their interest in fighting. But it's up to you guys now if you want to let them run or if you want to finish them off.
Oh, hey, we gotta finish them off.
I got one more left in me, so I'm gonna get a bit closer over here. hiding behind a statue, because that's what I do.
Fucking cowardly sorcerer.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna... let's see. Let's put that large burst. Oh, I can't get that fucker over there. He's hiding too. I'll get all these motherfuckers here.
Yeah, get me too. Indiscriminate killing.
Yeah, I know the second person's mouth I'm shitting into when they go to sleep.
Alright, since it's my last action, I'm gonna Benny it. And then I'm gonna try to get a raise on that baby.
Ooh. Oh, he rolled a one. Oh, he's doing it.
He's gonna Benny it again.
Oh, and he gets it.
Oh,
can you believe that?
Excellent.
Fuckers. Alright. I'm gonna start at the top here. Two wounds. Six wounds.
Jeez. Oh my
God. Holy cow.
Magno, next one's for you.
Oh, God.
It's fine. I can take it.
Are you
I
going?
Got three bennies.
Are you going? You get a free soak. You want to take a free soak? See what happens?
I'm going to vigor, right?
Yeah. So you knock it down to one.
Soak one.
You can spend the Benny and take.
Yeah, you got more bennies. Try it.
Oh yeah, dude, I'm on this.
You still soak one.
What have we got to lose, right?
A Benny.
Still soak
Jeez.
One.
All right, the last one.
Well, it's not like you're gonna die, right? It's just a roll on the chart.
Your Benny or your life.
Jeez.
Doesn't soak any.
Alright, well.
He soaks
shit
one.
Shit happens.
He still soaks one.
But I thought you only take the highest.
Yeah, he got a six and then you got a five also, so that's enough to soak one.
Yeah, but if you keep rolling, don't you let that. You don't keep your
no,
highest
you
roll.
Take
you?
The best, no, yeah, oh, you keep the best.
Alright, then that's what
highest roll.
That's what he's at, minus two. Alright then.
I'm fine. No,
that fucker here. Only one wound. Jeez, I'm disappointed.
Yeah. Loser. You're a failure.
This guy here. Another, just one wound. Next one is Skull Nasher. Oh, easy on you. I took it easy on you. Just a shaking. So, fine. Yeah, that was my, exit. Six skills. What about you, Curious Dickhead?
I love this game.
All right, Turok.
All right, Turok. Turok is going to slash a cult member with his sword. And then drop his sword and grab cult member three and bite off his ear.
So, yes. All right, so it's a minus two to your actions.
I'm sorry, he couldn't hear you. What'd you say?
Sorry.
I couldn't resist.
Holy shit, you got a D12 in fighting?
Nice.
Alright. So that's the sword attack, I would imagine. So.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay, he goes down. And you're going to kind of grapple the other guy, so.
Yeah, so is that a minus four?
Minus. Yes,
minus
it is.
Two.
No, it's a second action. He's making two attacks, really.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's a minus four offhand. He's grabbing them.
The bennies are flying tonight.
Oh my goodness. Bennies are coming everywhere now.
Look at all that blood. It's so pretty.
It's not going to happen.
It was A for effort, man. A for effort.
All right, Curtius.
All right.
Can you even see anything?
Not from there, nope.
Yeah, that's why I'm going to run. Allow me to run. I'm fleet-footed, so I get to...
D10.
Do a D10.
Fucking amateur hour.
Wow. Shots fired.
What? Only a 6? What's going on with you? No, 33?
I pat him on the ass as he runs by. Go get him!
I'm going to take the amateur hour comment in...
in the spirit that it was meant?
In the spirit, yeah. Kind of comedy to me.
Well, thanks for joining the fray.
Yeah, thanks for getting involved.
Sorry we woke you up.
That's the sorcerer.
All right, hey, so now, Curtius.
Yeah.
Before you
I got minus on that, right?
Well, you got some minuses, but you also are going, because he's partially in cover, I'm going to allow that guy cover based on your firing through the statue. So.
Yep.
So he is going to have, let me add it to it.
Sure.
I won't tell you because
we want it to be a surprise.
It'll be a surprise.
When he goes, sorry guys, only rolled a 30.
Yeah, there you go. It's all yours. Fire away. Not like it's going to matter anyway, but. Well, only one wound. That's enough to knock him down.
I'm worthless.
Sorry, guys. We only killed him in one shot.
So you are now standing in a room covered in blood and guts. There's entrails dripping off the statues, and there's people, you know, curled up into fetal positions holding in their intestines. There's all types of crazy stuff. And underneath the sacrificial altar, covered in red fluid, is a large stone, roughly the size of... who's the biggest dude there? I would say Magna. The stone itself, or from where you're standing, is roughly the size of your torso.
I have a raging boner, and I'm going for it.
I'm going to get it.
I call dibs.
I'm bigger than you.
I'll fucking kill my own party members for the stone.
I will skull fuck every one of you.
I'll scorch you assholes.
So, as you, I take it you're all up having to look at the stone, I guess.
Oh yeah. What is its size relationship in terms of Magnus's penis?
It's huge.
It's enormous. It's
ginormous.
I've got bulging muscles, but a very small penis.
That's what happens, you know, when these take those steroids and shit.
Steroids, yeah. That's right.
Yeah. Bovine steroids back in those days.
You know how you get those steroids, right? You have to go right to the source.
You have to
milk that bull.
So as you're standing around the table, you realize that it's not really one giant stone, but a number of stones, and there are 5 separate stones in total.
And there's 5 of us.
Coincidence.
Go figure.
We won't have to fight over this shit.
Oh no, I'm gonna kill you all and leave. Take yours. Okay. Right now, I'll let you have one. I'm not that smart, actually. I wouldn't know that.
All right, so are you each gonna grab a stone?
Of course.
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Excellent. So first of all,
cursed.
I have to pick.
We're all out of bennies, by the way.
I know, it's perfect. It worked out exactly the way I was hoping it would be. I mean,
I was gonna take two.
Let's go take two.
Let me see now.
Is everyone grabbing their own stones or someone else's stones?
I'll show you yours if you show me mine.
So that was in Death of a Tyrant.
Yeah, we played that adventure.
Okay, I'm going to get Magnus to roll a d20 and tell me what you get.
Oh, that's not very nice. A d20.
Yep.
I mean, Savage Rolls doesn't use a d20.
I rock that too.
This is a table.
I explode.
You? What do you say you got?
I got a 2.
A 2?
A whopping 2.
All right. Well, there is.
Someone's having dice spasms over there.
There is worse rolls. You have a. The gem that you grab is clear. It doesn't seem to have any type of. It just looks like a beautiful gem. And that's it.
Cool.
It has a cash value, and you're happy about it. You're not exactly sure yet, but it's...
I swallow it.
Okay, I'm going to go with Courteous next. Ooh, look, D20. That must be Azumet. Are you going to take that roll, Eric?
I'm still rolling. There we go.
You going to take that 10?
Yep. Oh. Well, it's not a trade die, so I can't spend bennies, and I don't even know what I'm rolling for, so.
Okay, oh shoot, I just missed it. I just closed up on me again.
I did mention that clear is my favorite color, right?
All right, Eric, what did you roll again?
10.
A 10? You have a clear, precious stone as well. And it seems to be a little bit larger than Magnus's stone.
Of course.
But it looks to be worth fairly valuable to you.
Magic, knowledge, arcana?
Roll it. This one here has no effects.
Alright. Well, you want it, Turok? It has no effect. I'll trade you.
Alright, Turok, you get to roll your d20.
I rolled a 2.
You rolled a 2? You yeah. Also... What's everyone rolling like 10 or less for? This sucks. Alright, so... you're just getting like the money gems. Like, come on. You also find a gem roughly the same size as Magnus's. Okay.
My stone's bigger than yours.
Skull Dasher.
I'm still frothing at the mouth with the blood of my enemies.
D20,
sir. Eating that guy's asshole.
He's like, who cares about pretty stones?
All you hear is him every once in a while he mumbles, "Frog dick."
This is chewy.
I cannot notice the difference between these gems and this hemorrhoid the size of a corn nut.
Tastes right. Like chicken.
All right, Skull Gasher. D20.
Oh, I rolled a 9.
Oh, you rolled a 9. Son of a bitch! All right, you also find
a gem that's not magical.
A precious, a stone that's called a precious tear, and it seems to be worth. It's not as... It's almost as big as Atsumet's. Almost. Atsumet's is still bigger. And I'm talking about stones.
Yeah, compensating.
Courteous. D20.
Watch him get... you get 30 magical arrows of plus 40 hitting. I don't need them. I'll leave them.
Did we lose Courteous Decimus?
No, I rolled.
What did you get? I didn't see it.
Oh,
18.
18?
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
He turns into a frog penis.
The stone that Courteous grabs has a greenish, is a kind of a greenish crystal. And yes, and it seems to have like a swirling motion on the inside, and it's just kind of a, it looks very different than the ones that you guys grabbed. Game purposes, Courteous, your charisma will drop by -1. You now gain the beast friend edge.
But I am only... I'm smashing him in the head and taking his.
But only towards snakes and similar beasts.
I love this show.
He's Harry Potter.
He's Harry Potter.
And you tend to flick your tongue a lot in the air and go. Apparently, it is a snake charmer first tier. Alright, so. The guys
so
who
really
rolled.
You really are a silver tongue devil.
So the two guys who rolled the 2 have a gem that's worth 100 moons. Eric rolled a 10, so his gem is worth 500 moons.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck your ghost.
Turok, you rolled a 9, 2. Didn't you? No, okay, who rolled 2. A 9?
Well, that was a D12.
Yeah, that was an accident.
Oh, didn't I see it? Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Alright, well, forget that. And let's see. There's so many D10s there, right? So many rolls. Alright, so Magda, you rolled a 2, right?
Yeah, what?
Courteous rolled an 18. Eric rolled a 10. Turok, what did you roll?
2.
2 as well, so your worth is 100. And Skull Nasher, what did you get?
9.
A 9. Oh, sorry. So you got the 9. Yours is worth 450 moons.
Damn.
So as you, as Eric, or sorry, as Courteous grabs the last stone from the placeholder, you feel a sudden shake and a tear or emotions taking place in the temple, and it seems like everything is starting to shake violently, and suddenly a large chunk of debris falls from the ceiling as if the temple is going to collapse in on itself. You hear a vicious moaning and wailing coming from deep in the below, in the bowels of the tower. Everything is starting to shake. All of you will have to make a dramatic roll. You have to get 7s. Oh, I got it right here. Story. You have 4 rounds to roll 6 successes in agility to get out unharmed. So we're going to go with Skull Gasher first. So no success there. Alright, roll again. You can use Benny's if you need to.
Yeah, I accidentally spent a Benny on my gem roll.
Okay.
That I shouldn't have been allowed to spend.
Okay, that's no problem.
So you... Yeah, me too.
Yeah, oh, yeah,
yeah
me
so
as well.
Did I.
Yeah.
We all did, as a matter of fact.
So you got two raises so far.
Okay.
That's three successes.
Three. Yep.
Should I keep going?
Keep going. You got two more rolls.
Fuck my goat.
Okay, one more roll.
Goat fuckers.
You never rolled your wild die, did you? I'm gonna get you rolled that one again.
Yeah, it should. It should be rolling two dice.
It should be. Yeah. Did it?
Yeah. Oh, did you goat?
All right. So,
well, one die was for his goat.
As you're running out and jumping over the tower and trying to get down and out, you were hit several times by large stones.
Oh no!
And you take 9 damage. So I think is one wound, I believe, for you.
I want to spend my Benny that I'm supposed to have and soak it.
Okay. The strength I require to rise from the ashes of the past, reborn as we are legion. You gonna roll your vigor? And
in darkness. Oh, you could can't you just spend a Benny to soak it and you don't have to roll a vigor?
No.
No.
Okay.
If you're shaken, yeah, but if you got wounds, you have to score one for every four for every wound you want to soak.
So you take a wound, but you get out okay. Turok.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it to you, sir. Your turn. 6 successes. Okay, that's first
how many
try.
Rounds did you, sir?
You got 4 tries. So that's 1 success. Okay, that's 3 tries.
There you go.
As you're getting out, you are struck as well by multiple stones.
We are the children of the night. We are the denizens of the dawn.
So... you take 6 damage. So you have a toss of 7, so you don't take any damage whatsoever. Courteous, your turn.
Oh my gosh.
Just slides off my oily body.
So that's 1 success. That's 2 successes. That's 3 successes. 4 successes. Oh, you get struck as well.
Maybe he should have been given a +2. I think he's got fleet footed.
I am fleet footed.
I will allow that.
Still only 5 successes.
And you only take 6 damage anyway. So you take 1 wound.
Duh.
Okay, Atsimut, your turn.
It's my first wound in my life.
Oops. Never mind.
It was really only your pride.
Okay, so you got 1 success?
No, it's -2. I'm lame, so I don't have one.
Right.
1. I only have 1 success. I'm going to be buried under that temple.
We're going back for his gem.
1 success, that's it.
That's it. Oh, wow. All right, so for you, you receive... uh-oh, 1 aced. So I'll roll 1 more.
Nine. That's 1 wound.
That's 1 wound, yep.
And I got bennies. So.
Yep.
Show off.
Oh, look. Okay. You can't be making fun of the wizard anymore. You just can't.
Yeah.
Oh, they still will, because they're assholes.
You're still jealous.
And Magna, you're the wounded guy who has, like, -3 to everything here.
-3 or -2?
Oh, sorry, yeah, -2, sorry. Let's look at that.
So making, what am I making, agility?
You have to just make an agility roll, yep. And your minuses are already included.
Okay.
So just straight rolls.
So first roll.
Okay, nothing.
I suck. There we go.
So that's 2 successes. Okay, one more roll.
I'm thinking about that goat.
You should be riding it.
Oh, I am.
And here we go for your damage.
How?
1 aced. So that's 10.
Oh my god!
That's 14.
Oof. But because I am Magnus, I can make that vigor roll, right?
That's right.
Or is that only for... That's for any damage, right?
That's for any damage, yep.
All right. Chafing damage. If I'm riding the goat out there.
I used lanolin. It was kind of counteracted it. So I think I'm going down.
No, it's only 1 damage.
So
anyway.
It's only 1 damage.
Oh, okay.
3 wounds.
Yeah, so, yeah, 14 on your toughness 7 is a... it's 2 wounds.
No. You got the target, the race calculator there at the bottom.
Yeah, it says that the target was 7 and it was a 14.
That's 1 raise, so it's 1 wound.
No, that's the damage.
Well, what's your parry? Your toughness is 7.
Right.
Yeah.
Against a 14, that's only 1 raise.
Yeah, but if it hits, if it matches his toughness. Oh, yeah, no, you're right. You're right. Absolutely right. Sorry. It's getting late for me here. So, as Magnus is the last one stumbling and staggering out through the collapsing tower and jumping down over the ledges and trying to get out, you manage all to survive the collapse unscathed with 1 final roll that requires from everyone to see if you dropped your diamond as you were running. Roll 1 agility roll, flat agility roll.
Modified by damage and everything?
Yeah, just whatever it is.
Can you Benny it?
If you have a Benny, you can, yep.
Oh, I got one. Thank God.
Oh.
Tura can't let that thing go.
No, sir.
Boolean be praised.
He's got like
I gotta spend another penny.
Only 100 moon worth, but you ain't letting that shit go.
Oh, I told you I swallowed mine, so.
Fuck.
Not only did I keep them, I picked up the other ones you guys dropped on the way out.
Courteous Butterfingers Maximus over here keeps dropping his junk.
So
that's a euphemism for his goat.
I lost my goat. I lost my gem.
Life's fuck not worth game. Living, man. Fuck this game.
You just stay in the temple while it glasses.
Stay in the temple.
So
I deserve to die.
Just sit down and get comfortable.
So Courteous,
bring me the hemlock.
In your trials and tribulations of trying to get out of the tower, you somehow lose the stone that you were collecting, that you just had. Unfortunately, the effects right now may be permanent, or they may be temporary, but you're still have under the influence of the effects of the snake charmer.
What kind of sounds are we making with it?
Fuckers Lotus.
Oh my god.
I said this the last game that I played with Eric and Matt and Daniel and that. It was, if we just played the game and just did it, went through, we finished in an hour. But no.
Yeah.
That's not possible with any of us, apparently. It seems that way.
I'm happy to know that I feel proud and privileged that I fit right in.
And so does my penis.
Flawless.
Flawless. Right into the puckered lotus.
Well, guys, that's the end of this adventure, and it was a success for all of you guys, except for poor old Curtius.
Oh, man. I felt that was very successful.
Oh, you lost your stones, man.
I think that was good.
Maybe.
But you got a goat, so... got a goat. I mean, is it really a loss?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I still got the goat. As long as you got the goat.
Yeah,
but didn't he get the goat because he had the stone? Now if you lose the stone, you lose the goat.
The goat's like, fuck you, man. God, you're a loser. You got no lawyer. Stone. The goat leaves him. I'm going to the sorcerer. He's hot.
Man,
got a cool stone.
Can't you just let